All right, it's Talk to Brock, the new 105.3 FM, 309. Dan O'Malley is here, J.D. Ryan, Eddie Boyd, Trey Trent Home, KLLI Foot with Traffic. There goes Brainchild. Hey, Brainiac. You don't have your two-way with you, do you?
I don't know how much easier you can make it.
And I don't see a cowbell around his neck.
Mm-mm. In obvious defiance.
Yeah. Who does he think he is? France?
Yeah.
Hello?
Yes, I'm here.
Come in here and tell me what that Deucey guy wanted. Guy from Channel 4.
Mike Deucey?
I guess.
Sports
wants to
guy.
Come on for something. All I heard was Trey was on the phone with him, and he said Mardi Gras.
Hmm.
So it's like, yeah, he can come on if he shows us it's...
Okay.
What did he want?
He is the honorary chairman for the... It's called the 5K Mardi Gras run benefiting Captain Hope's kids.
Those are crippled ones?
I think so.
That's going to take them all day.
It benefits.
Oh, they're not the ones that run?
No. I would guess not.
Because I'd say that'd be a good charity fundraiser.
Yeah.
Because I watch.
No.
Yeah.
It's regular people.
I pay money. Well, what's the magic of that? Normal people running a 5K?
Right.
I'm not going to pay to see that.
I believe you pay to be in it.
Yeah. Something else I'd pay to watch.
Mm.
Special Olympics.
Okay.
Wouldn't you?
I've seen them, actually.
Fun to watch.
My ex-wife used to work with them. Special Olympics Committee. It's very interesting. These kids try very hard.
I know.
Quick.
I hate to repeat something I've read, but that's really one of my favorite posters. Have you seen it? The retarded kid running.
Mm-mm.
And it said, even if you win the Special Olympics, you're still retarded.
No, I think I missed that one.
So what does he want?
He wants to come on the show and talk about the race and...
Well, we've already talked about it.
Helps kids.
What did he say when I said, show us his cans?
There was an awkward silence. But he said he'd come into the studio or do it over the phone and...
Hmm. Let me think. Let's have a quick show meeting. I'll turn the mics off here for a second. You at work in your car. F you. Either everybody's onto it or it just doesn't work.
It's worked before.
Yeah. Worked on Marty Griffin.
Mm-hmm. Good.
Yeah, Marty Griffin was the best.
Him, the doctor of love.
Black guy?
Yeah.
Yeah. Ah, you could have done that with a gun or a German Shepherd.
Yeah.
You to see how we're number one.
Yes.
Let's see. Do we want him in the studio? When did he want to come up?
He said the only thing, you know, he has sportscast at 6. So it would have to be but it's...
Tell him 6:15. Act like you don't... Act like you have no idea what his schedule is. Well, I'm, you know, I'm doing a sports cast at 6:20. We have 6:15 open.
Well, he said...
Well, I'm on the air. 6:15 is what's open.
He already told me, because he's like, oh, I got to be down at American Airlines Center, do a broadcast at 6.
Oh, heaven!
What? He's got to be at the American Airlines Center, what?
At 6.
At 6? Well, how's he going to do his... Oh, does he want to do this today?
No, tomorrow.
Yeah. Oh.
They start off when there's a game, like one of their top stories is he'll do a little blib at the first of the newscast.
Call him back. Do you have his number right now?
I can go get it.
Was he at his desk?
I don't know.
Come back in with your cell phone. I want to hear you call him.
What do you want me to say?
Just keep picking the time where he's not available. Just be totally oblivious to his TV schedule. And he's got to come in. What was the Mardi Gras thing? I missed that.
It's just it's called the Mardi Gras run.
Okay, well, he's got to come in and he's got to show us his cans. We'll give him some beats.
Ah, Jesus!
Well, go.
He's one of these sports guys that takes himself pretty seriously. I don't think you're going to...
You don't think?
You're going to swing him.
Well, then he's not going to get any promotion. I'll promote the event, but I ain't promoting him.
Okay.
How does a sports guy take himself seriously?
They almost all do. Dale Hansen
doesn't.
He's about the only one that doesn't. Doesn't the rest of them do?
About Scott Murray. Is he still doing sports?
Still doing sports. Very serious about it. They take on a lot of good causes, a lot of kids and charities.
Well,
and
everybody does that. Dale Hansen does the cars. What is it? Al-Anon. What does he do? Don't write off the kid, off the car.
A Dallas Can Academy.
Yeah, he does that. Scott Murray has something.
They all do the MDA thing. They all just TV people notoriously really don't have good sense of humor.
I'm sorry, he's got to come in with his nipples out. And we'll break out the German Shepherd.
Mm-mm. Help me!
All right. Hang on, I got a scratch right here. I didn't wipe good. You ever do that?
Not wipe good?
Yeah.
I try not to.
Well, I mean...
Yeah. And then for later it gets...
You got the itchies.
Jesus.
And it's like, you dig and dig and you still got the butt itchies.
Yeah, I try not to do that.
I got,
it's probably happened to everybody.
I got the scrubbing dookie bubbles. I got it. And by the way, you're never spending the night with me again. Ever.
You wanted me to drive home and get and kill myself? The roads were treacherous.
I understand, but there's no reason. Now, Eddie, you want to buy a leather couch for $100?
What are you talking about?
It originally cost me $3,000.
What is wrong with the couch?
You slept on it naked.
I always sleep naked.
I get up in the middle of the night.
Well, yeah, you
go get the hell out of me, by the way. And Sasquatch here is running around stark effing naked.
I was just getting a drink. You scared the crap out of me at 3 a.m. I'm just in the kitchen and I was getting a drink. I didn't know you were going to be up. That's the way I sleep. Sorry.
Now I got to sell the couch.
Oh, you don't.
I am not keeping that leather couch after your naked, white, hairy man ass has been all over it.
It's not hairy anymore. It's been lasered. Sorry. What are you doing up walking around at 3 o'clock?
I always get up in the middle of the night to get something to drink.
Oh. Sorry. Sorry.
You slept naked on my furniture.
I always sleep naked.
Anything else you said on naked that I need to sell?
No. Wait a minute. Yes. All of your leather.
I'm selling it to Eddie.
Oh. I can't buy it.
And you had to sleep on the longest couch that I got. I can't even flip the cushions over. They're not reversible.
I didn't hurt it. I'm quite
you
clean.
You were on it naked.
I'm quite clean.
You were on it. Remember that very one time we were doing the TV show and we're doing a shoot in somebody's apartment and you sat in that chick's bathtub and they scrubbed it for an hour and a half because everybody knows how nasty you are.
I'm not nasty. I'm very clean. Quite clean, thank you. You're the one digging dookie out between your cheeks.
That's only because I didn't want good.
Good. Well, I do. And your couch is fine. I'll have it cleaned if you prefer.
Just the idea that you were on it naked.
Just the fact that you weren't even going to let me stay.
I let you stay.
I let you drive. I drove you all the way up there, and it's slicker than owl stuff. Yeah, good night. Well, it's nasty. I know. Thanks. Slams the door in my face.
Did I not say thank you?
You said thank you, yeah.
Okay.
Thank you. Can I stay the night? Uh-uh.
The least you could have done was left your drawers on.
That's just the way I sleep. I don't like sleeping.
So not only was your old man ass all over my couch, your old man fried marbles were all over my couch, and your old man penis, and all the hair that's still left there. You rolled around naked on my couch.
None of them are old man anything, first. Second of all, your couch is fine. If you'd like, I'd have it cleaned. But I didn't do anything to it. I'm perfectly clean. Sorry. Thank you for letting me stay.
Hold on a second. You got his phone number?
I had it. Oh, there it is.
Calling.
Hey, you want him at 6:15?
Yes. We'll devote an entire segment. See what he says. Are you calling? Is it ringing? Every time he picks a time, he's working. Pick that time. Let me know if you get his voicemail. Why is it TV people have got an attitude?
Mike?
You know, they're just very serious.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was trying to get Mike Ducey. All right. I'll call back. Thank you.
Who is that? SP Skewed. Let us know as soon as you get a hold of him. Come back in about 10 minutes. Try him again.
Okay. Here, if you want those are the press releases about the
sports anchor and Dallas Stars team. Okay.
Thank you.
Sports director Mike Ducey, Dallas Stars right wing Aaron Downey. Been named honorary coach since 2006. Yes, it's fascinating. I don't understand how TV people cop an attitude.
They just have an image they have to present to be considered serious and journalists.
So?
Well, that's just it.
Like Scott Sams won't call us back.
And he was a big fan of the TV show that we used to have.
Yeah, he's always been a big fan.
Well, you have got on the radio and kind of called him a fat ass.
He is a fat ass. Well, and he knows it. And he's trying to lose weight. He's even got a posting on the WFAA website. He's fat.
I know.
He's huge.
I know. But
he's afloat.
They don't like to be made fun of. They like to be considered serious journalists.
Don't be fat. It's like chicks. When they do something stupid, you call them stupid. They don't call me names. Stop being it. It'll take the pressure off both of us if you stop being the things that I'm calling you. If you'll stop doing that, I'll stop calling you the names. Everybody's happy.
Yes.
So stop being all these different things. I'll write it down on a list for you if it helps you. If you won't be these, I won't say it.
Yeah, they don't get that.
Can you come this weekend and get the couch out of my house? Okay. Now I gotta go back.
I can't believe you're gonna sell your couch for $100. You gotta
slept. Oh, I'm not just selling the couch. I gotta sell the whole set because if I buy a new one, it ain't gonna match the other two. I am never sitting on that couch again. You were on it naked.
So?
You didn't even put a sheet underneath you. You just had the stuff on top.
I had the thing
on top. Your nasty body was on my furniture.
So? Nothing nasty about my body. It's a lovely body. And it's getting in better shape all the time. You ever quit it? Your couch is very comfortable. And I took the long one because the short, I can't fit on the short one. You told me I could sleep there.
I didn't tell you you could sleep naked. And let me tell you something else. Mm. Your body lit up by the refrigerator in the middle of the night
Yes. Is
not a pretty sight. It's not a pretty body.
It is. It's getting better all the time. It's not perfect. I'm not there yet, but I'm getting in better shape. Quit looking at me. You see me naked now. I feel somehow violated.
I thought somehow I'd left the door open and a sleet man had snuck into the house.
Sleet man?
Sleet.
Sleet man.
Big blob. Pimples all over.
I got no pimples.
Somebody does.
No pimples.
Somebody in front of my fridge last night
did.
I have
no pimples.
Well, then it was the way the refrigerator light hit your ass.
I guess. Because I've been tanning and I have no pimples. Nor hair. You scared me as much as I scared you, I'm quite sure.
I had clothes on.
Well,
I always sleep with clothes on. Just in the event something happens in the middle of the night, you got to jump up, you got to run, go shoot somebody, you got to get out of the house. You never sleep naked. Especially on company's furniture. Oh, that's rude.
Sorry. Didn't occur to me.
Bob McNeil spent the night at my house one time.
Mm-hmm.
I put extra blankets down just in case he slept naked.
Okay. Maybe you should have done that.
Because, you know, he probably looks like a Shar-Pei naked.
Very possibly. He has lost quite a bit of weight.
All right. I'm ready to start news now.
Okay.
What is this thing for Captain Hope's kids? In case we don't have him on, which we probably won't. Pre-registered by February 19th. Day of the race. I don't see it. Eddie, look at that and see, can you find that? All right, you ready to go?
Sure.
And the roads weren't that bad last night.
They were horrible.
You got a four-wheel drive.
I don't care. It's solid, solid ice. Coming down your street, looked like an ice rink at Reunion Arena. You couldn't even walk. You had to walk through the grass to get to your house. Your porch was so slick.
So?
Well,
there's not a lot of traffic on my porch. There are a lot of traffic on the street. You have a four-wheel drive.
At 20 degrees, it's nothing but ice.
Well, you know, normally, if I'm going to extend the courtesy of staying at my home,
mm-hmm.
Don't touch my furniture.
I'm sorry I had to sleep somewhere.
You didn't have to sleep naked.
Okay. Yeah. That's the way I feel comfortable.
It's making me gurgle bile right now just thinking about it. What is it, Ryan?
Sorry.
Say it again, Ryan.
Why can't you do that stuff naked?
Do what?
Jump up and shoot somebody.
What if you got to chase them outside?
Why can't you do it naked?
Because I'm not doing it naked. Dip. All right, you ready to go?
Oh, sure.
Got to go back to the room store and buy new furniture.
Sorry. I offer to have it cleaned.
That's not going to change the fact that you were on it naked.
And dirty it. Probably increase the value. Never mind.
328, J.D. Ryan's on the new 105.3 FM Talk with news.
Thank you, Russ. Beginning getting in shape. It's brought to us by 24-Hour Fitness. There's one near you at 1-800-204-2400. Wednesday, February 26, 2003. Birthdays today. Go to...
And you ain't going to be ready for Happy the Clown.
I am too.
I saw you naked.
I'm doing good. I've lost 6 pounds. I got about 10 to go. And when we get it finally done somewhere in the summer, I'm sure I'll be quite ready.
You're not going to be ready in 3 weeks.
I'm going to be better. I missed this week because of the weather. This Monday and Tuesday, or Monday and Wednesday.
Go ahead.
Michael Bolton's 50 today. Johnny Cash, 71. Fats Domino turned 75. And Tony Randall, 83. President Bush called Saddam Hussein a master of disguise and delay today and mocked the Iraqi leader for disclosing some weapons that he previously denied were in his arsenal on a day in which the White House threatened Saddam with trial as a war criminal in the event of war. By the way, he's going to be on 60 Minutes 2 tonight at 8 o'clock with Dan Rather. I saw clips of that, of the deal, and it's obviously we don't understand what Saddam Hussein's saying because he's speaking Iraqi.
Right.
But so Dan Rather asks the question and then answers it. basically they put the words up on the screen several times, and he goes, well, what are you going to do about these weapons? And then he told us we didn't have any weapons, and he goes on to answer his own question with just the words. It's just an odd interview. You don't really.
Why don't they do it like they do with any other translation thing? You let the person speak in their own language for a second,
right.
And then you gradually bring in the translator.
That's what I thought they were going to do, but they didn't on a lot of these. So those are just the clips they put on the web at CBSNews.com.
Well,
I was thinking we'd have something, but I no point in playing Dan Rather talking to himself. Here's something for the anti-abortion activist to chew on. Saddam Hussein almost didn't happen. When he was a fetus, his mom tried to abort him, the story is. I think how different the world might have been had she succeeded. Saddam's father died while Saddam's mom was pregnant. She became so depressed she repeatedly tried to kill herself and her unborn child. When Saddam was finally born, she wouldn't even look at him. CIA profiler says Saddam sees himself as having a heroic role to play in the world stage because as a boy he ran away to live with his uncle who continued to tell him he was going to grow up to be a great Arab leader. Let's see, anything else? There's others have said Saddam Hussein may be a bloodthirsty tyrant, but he's not crazy. He knows exactly what he's doing, and his actions are understandable, and predictable. So, that's on tonight.
Good. I can't wait to see it.
It's going to be a promo piece. It's no point in watching it. Back in 1997, Jesse Ingram, the owner of the bar in Aurora, Illinois, called George O's place, was furious. He'd been burglarized 3 times in 1 month, so he booby-trapped the joint. He rigged up the inside of the bar windows so that anyone breaking in would get a serious electrical jolt. And to make sure that the burglars knew the place was booby-trapped, he put up big signs outside telling them what would happen if they broke in. Just 5 days later, 37-year-old Larry Harris was drunk and high, broke into George O's place, ran into the booby trap, was smoked by 220 volts of electricity through his body. He died. No criminal charges were ever filed, but the burglar's family took Jesse to court. This week, they were awarded $75,000 for him breaking into that guy's bar.
For what?
Wrongful death.
It's not wrongful death. The guy broke into the place. Was he already in by the time the booby trap hit him?
Yes. According to this, the lawyer said you can't set this type of booby trap. Property isn't worth a human life. And he added,
well, yeah, exactly. That's why you don't break into somebody's house. Your life isn't worth whatever you're going to find in that house. That works both ways.
Yeah. But apparently the jury said, no, it's worth $75,000 because he broke in.
For wrongful death.
Correct.
Even though the guy brought it on himself.
Correct. And the place was posted.
Oh, it had warning signs?
And the guy put warning signs outside the door.
How does a jury do that?
I don't know. They continue to do it, though. I guess they just stack the jury with people that are just stupid.
Both sides get to pick the jury. Whenever I went to court in Tarrant County, they give you a whole list of, civil. I don't know if civil's different. Criminal, you get a list of everybody.
Right.
And they're basic, whatever they filled out on the jury pool poll thingy. And so you get to look at them and go, okay, I want this one as a juror. I want this one. Another reason that we opted for no trial is everybody on the jury was at least 10 years older than me. It's like nobody was even close.
And it cooked you.
Well, as it turned out, we didn't have to go to trial because they abandoned their case.
Certainly.
I just don't understand how somebody could award somebody. You've gone out. First of all, the thing's posted, so you know there's danger. Danger lies within.
Well, they say he was drunk and on drugs, so he probably didn't see the sign.
It's his own fault then.
You're right. You're right. No argument, except they say you can't booby trap a house. They say, what if firefighters or police had to get in there?
Firefighters and cops can read, and chances are they're not going to be all doped up when they get there to read the sign.
That's absurd. Yeah. He won the cash.
Not as absurd as sleeping on somebody's couch naked.
She'll never be invited again, so it won't be an issue. Baseball Hall of Fame information in today. The redesigned Veterans Committee failed to elect anybody to the Hall of Fame today. Brooklyn Dodger first baseman and New York Mets manager Joe Hodges came closest, getting 50 votes, falling 11 votes shy. To be elected, a person has to be listed on at least 3/4 of the 81 ballots that were returned. Dionne Warwick, who was arrested at the airport last year after authorities found marijuana in her bag, is blaming somebody else for putting it there. Quote, apparently somebody that didn't want to get caught thought it would be better off in somebody else's bag, end quote. Arrested in May, she was charged with misdemeanor after baggage screeners at Miami International Airport said they found marijuana joints inside an empty lipstick container in her bag. Charges were dropped after Warwick agreed to plea bargain and including a drug treatment program.
Well, if they were planted on her, why did she plea her way out?
Looking for somebody to blame. It's got to be somebody else that put that in there.
All right, go ahead.
Okay. Country Music Television, CMT, has announced the hosts of the upcoming Flameworthy Awards.
The what?
Flameworthy Awards. Flameworthy. That's just one of their award shows.
Is it Great White?
No.
They're not going to host it?
Stop it.
Is it?
No. No. It's going to be Toby Keith.
And Great White.
No. Pamela Anderson.
Should be Great White.
No. And you ask yourself, why Pamela Anderson?
Why they call it the Flameworthy Awards?
Flameworthy, that's just what the country music calls it.
The Great White?
No, it's the Great White. He's not in it. Well, there is actually a country connection if you look at it this way. She's dating Kid Rock, who is tight with Hank Williams Jr. That's about it. It's the only reason anybody can figure out why Pamela Anderson was picked to host this.
They make more sense to have Great White.
They would. April the 2nd.
They should get Great White.
Maybe they'll be a special guest.
They should get that Jack Russell guy,
mm-hmm.
Great White. They should do that. That would be funny.
Uh-huh.
I would laugh.
That would be good. MTV, speaking of video channels, you may or may not be aware of this. They were supposed to mark the beginning of MTV's week-long MC Battles freestyle rap contest. The first 1,000 aspiring MCs who showed up at the MTV studios in Times Square would have a chance to bust a rhyme in front of a panel of MTV and Def Jam judges for a chance to win a Def Jam recording contract and $25,000. However, more than 1,000 young urbans showed up, camping out overnight, and yesterday morning there was pandemonium in the streets as these eager young youths pushed and shoved each other to get to the front of the line. Four people were arrested for disorderly conduct. Two cops suffered minor injuries as they tried to basically manage the unruly MCs. NYPD had no choice but to ask MTV to cancel the contest, which they did.
Urban crowd?
Urban crowd. All MCs.
For some type of hip-hop thing?
Basically, yeah, it's like a reality show, who's the best freestyle rap contest. So, you get a shot at maybe getting a recording contract and $25,000 if you're a good rapper.
Mostly a black crowd.
Yes. Which follows my next story, which is rap wars are out of hand.
I'm not saying anything about the black community.
No.
It just seems like a lot of times you people are crazy. A black person, call up and explain this to me. Why you guys can't just, even the black award programs,
yeah.
Something happens there.
Yeah, they had to, well, they edited it out, but yeah, there was fighting and shoving and pushing. And there's.
I mean, if it was a mixed crowd, I could see the blacks jumping on the whites. That would be funny.
Yeah.
But you don't do it to your own brothers.
Mm-mm. And then there's the latest rap war incident. It's basically loads of speculation that Jam Master Jay was shot and killed by somebody connected to Murder, Inc.
That's what I think.
Jam Master Jay was working with 50 Cent.
Who is that? I keep hearing his name over and over.
Uh-uh.
Did he win anything in the Grammys or anything? Dan, do you know? But he was up for something, wasn't he? I've seen his name a lot over the... Is it a group or one guy? One guy?
50 Cent.
Eddie, go over to Wild and see, do they have any 50 Cent music?
50 Cent has a beef with Murder, Inc. In fact, the NYPD warned 50 Cent that his life was in danger the day after Jam Master Jay's shooting.
Yeah.
Last month, somebody shot up the reception area, the 11th floor offices of Violator Records and Violator Management, which represents 50 Cent. Then on Friday night...
Isn't it funny? Not only is the whole industry full of threats and killings and stuff, you got all these names...
Yeah, we got...
You got what's the name of the record company?
This is
Violator.
Violator Management.
And then you got Murder, Inc.
Murder, Inc., 50 Cent, Busta Rhymes.
Go ahead.
Okay. Then on Friday night, somebody shot up Busta Rhymes' SUV, which was just parked outside the Violator offices.
Are you sure? Because you said it was Sir Mix-a-Lot.
I'm reading it right here.
All right.
From MTV.
Yeah.
There were many who figured the Violator shooting came courtesy of Murder, Inc. It's a big plot.
I just don't get it.
I don't either.
And like I said before, why is it that country music can't do that to themselves?
Shoot each other?
Yeah. I mean,
they're
all dying of natural causes, which is driving me nuts. Thank God for alcohol.
They're not. A lot of very young, up-and-coming artists.
Hold on a second. Yes, Tino?
Yeah, I'm going to tell you about 50 Cent.
All right.
Well, Ja Rule is with Murder, Inc. I don't know if you know who Ja Rule is.
Mm-mm.
Well... 50 Cent does not like Ja Rule.
How come?
because he tries to, Ja Rule tries to act like he's a hardcore rapper, which he's not.
No, I can't stand his music.
And 50 Cent has made fun of him.
All right, so they're just making fun of each other, but why is it somebody wants somebody else dead? Does 50 Cent want Ja Rule dead?
Not necessarily. He just makes fun of him because, like I said, he thinks he's a big-time rapper, which he's not. And I guess Murder, Inc. supposedly wanted to get 50 Cent, but 50 Cent did not want to get him. He didn't want to go there, which he's with Eminem now.
Who is 50 Cent?
And, yeah, he signed with Eminem's rec label. Shady Aftermath.
Oh. Oh, Shady Slim?
Yeah.
I got it.
Eminem.
What is this, Eddie?
That's two of his songs.
Oh. All right, thanks, Atina.
No problem. Right.
How are we doing on spots, Eddie?
We need a break.
All right.
The second song is number 2 on the charts right now.
Oh, is it really?
Yeah.
Well, we'll just save it for after the break. I'm excited to hear it.
Me too.
50 Cent music.
Mm-hmm.
Are you done?
Yes, I'm done.
Go ahead.
News and information about this by 24 Hour Fitness. J.D. Ryan on the Talk of Rocks, Texas, the new 105.3 FM Talk.
More of the Russ Martin Show coming right up.
All right. And we got to do traffic here. Hi, Sugar Walls.
Hi there.
What are you doing?
Well, I'm just looking at what's not shut down anymore and what is shut down. I talked to a woman this morning that had been sitting on I-20 since last night.
How'd you talk to her?
On the phone.
Well, I mean...
She called in.
Called in where?
To Metro.
I don't even know the phone number there. How did she get it?
Well, you can have it if you want it.
People can just call into Metro?
Well, she called to KRLD.
Oh, I got it.
Yeah, you know, like the traffic tip hotline thingy.
And it rounds to you guys?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Well, yeah, because they operate out of here, too.
Oh.
And she's so, been sitting there since 7 o'clock last night and had not moved an inch just outside of Forney.
She on the side of the road or stopped in traffic?
Stopped in traffic over 13 hours all night long.
I don't get how you could do that. How could traffic be stopped for 13 hours?
Well, there were jackknife trucks, and they couldn't get them out of the way. Red Cross was having to go out and deliver food and take care of people. And
gasoline's what you run out of gas sooner or later.
Well, you have to turn your car off.
Ooh.
But it was kind of a mess. She was having to get in the back of her...
You can say that.
I can't say that.
I don't know if you can say that.
You say...
I don't talk about...
I can't say that.
I don't think you can say that. I think you can say whiz in a cup.
And excuse herself in a cup. Sorry.
That's all right.
I'm really embarrassed now.
That's all right. I hate the delay. Nobody heard it.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Bob McNeil's weird about bodily excrements and stuff like that.
Oh, okay.
I don't know what it is. Not that
well,
I really
then I should probably get on with business.
All right. Go ahead. What do you got?
Which is brought to you by Mitsubishi, Tylock Eye and Laser, and American Airlines. In Grand Prairie, eastbound I-30 before Northwest 19th Street, there is a jackknife semi-trailer. Southbound I-35 at Industrial, just south of the Mixmaster, the center lane is blocked. Southbound 35, let's see, well, that's going to be the same one, same stupid thing. Westbound 635 at I-35, Stimmons, there's a collision.
Wait a minute, how does a chick whiz in a cup?
Well.
Don't you guys dribble?
I guess she was just really careful about it. I didn't watch, and I didn't ask for details.
It didn't dawn on me until just now. I mean, guys could do that because we can aim. You guys got no aim.
Well, you know, I mean, we have to do it when we go to the doctor.
In a cup?
Well, yeah.
Well, I didn't know that. I thought maybe they'd give you a pie tin or something.
That would be even harder.
No, it wouldn't.
Yes, it would.
A pie tin would be harder to hit than a cup?
It would be easier to hit, but harder not to spill.
All right.
You see.
I'm just curious.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Let's see here. Eastbound I-20 at 310, the three left lanes are blocked by a crash. Westbound 635 before Plano Road, there's a crash, and there is still a closure in Balk Springs. Southbound 635 at I-20 is still shut down because of the ice. And in Grapevine, westbound 114 before Main, that's an overturned vehicle of some sort right smack in the middle of the roadway. And this also brought to you by Sears 72-hour sale. This Thursday through Saturday, get great savings throughout the store on the things you need right now. The sale starts February 27th, ends March 1st. Sears, where else? I'm Gail Lightfoot with traffic on the new 105.3 FM Talk, the talk that rocks Texas.
Thank you, Gail. All right, it's going to be cold again tonight, so anything left that is water will refreeze. 21 for the
open. Gail, are you still there? Gail.
What?
If somebody let you spend the night at their house, would you sleep naked on their couch?
Well, no.
Do you sleep naked normally, though?
That's not the point. Would you sleep naked on somebody's couch?
Well, no, I would dress in somebody else's house.
Thank you.
But I like to sleep naked
if it was just
in my own bed.
Maybe a girlfriend's house you've known forever.
I'm not your girlfriend.
You're a guy buddy.
I know, but I don't want to see you naked, and you're on my couch. You're on my furniture naked. You're naked on my furniture. Your naked body was on my leather furniture.
Okay, I get it. I got it.
Hold on a second. And Dan, don't nutbag chick on line four. I ain't selling that couch for $400. She wants all three of them for $400.
I didn't sleep on all of them. I know you're
But I got to get rid of all of them because you slept on a set. You couldn't have slept on just one thing that I got one thing of. You had to sleep on a group.
Did you get them at the room store?
Yes.
Then they're going to have the exact same model and that same couch.
I know, but I've had them for 3 years. They age.
Okay.
So just as I understand it, you think it would be rude to sleep nude on somebody's furniture.
Well, I would put a sheet or something on it if I thought I had to sleep nude.
And why do you got to sleep naked?
That's just the way I've always slept.
I know, but why?
I think he likes how the leather feels.
It's just comfortable.
Skin.
I sleep that way at home. I'm just comfortable that way. Sorry.
That's not natural to sleep naked.
It is totally natural.
It is not.
It's much more natural than having clothes on.
No, it's not. You have clothes on. You keep all your goods up next to you where they belong. And when you're naked, you dangle. Dangle is not, it's not natural.
It's not like they're whirling fan blades in bed with you.
That make any difference. Things can happen.
What? In bed.
You need to keep things packed close to your body, especially when you're on my damn furniture.
Fine.
Why don't you go do traffic for KBIL and stop giggling?
Cold, 21 for the low tonight, cloudy in mid-30s tomorrow, then some drizzle by Friday. It's just going to be cruddy all weekend, but at least warmer, 51 on Friday. We have 28 degrees currently at the Talk That Rocks Texas, the new 105.3 FM Talk. I'm sorry, I won't do it again. Well, needless, I won't the opportunity.
No.
But I drove you home.
That doesn't mean you can violate my furniture.
I didn't rape it, I slept on it.
Do you wake up with morning wood?
Sometimes.
So now, your hard has been up against my couch.
And the feel of leather in the morning is wonderful.
Sorry. It wasn't bad enough. I saw you naked in front of the refrigerator.
That was your fault for coming out at 3 o'clock in the morning.
You're going to get up off the couch.
Yes,
I at do. Least put clothes on if you're going to wander around in my house.
It was dark.
People already think we're queer as it is. Now you're running around my house naked.
You don't have to tell anybody.
That's too good of a story to let go.
Just getting a drink of water.
I don't keep water in the fridge.
You keep
I got
the
dispenser
door.
On the left.
Yeah. I had to get ice.
Yes, Glenda.
Yes, Russ. Should you have been hospitable to J.D. and put a sheet over the couch?
I gave him two blankets, two nice horse blankets. You know which kind I'm talking about?
Uh-huh.
The really nice thick ones. So
yeah.
What does he do? He puts them on top of himself instead of sticking one down and one on top. He's got to rub his big, fat, white ass all over it and then wake up in the morning with a boner.
Hey, Russell. How do you know why he was really
hey,
on there?
You don't know me well enough to call me Russell. Second of all, I know he was naked.
Did it stink after he got up?
I haven't
no,
smelled it.
It doesn't stink. I'm very clean. It's quite
clean. J.D., I think
you mean
Russ was over there sniffing it and checking it, don't you?
Well, aren't you cute? Here's an idea. Well, that was smart.
Yeah.
I bleeped that dog and said S on the air.
Yeah, you wouldn't want dog to slip out.
So you mean to tell me that there would be no odors coming from your body?
No. I'm clean.
Stick your pants down in, stick your hand down in your drawers right now.
I'm completely clean.
Stick your hand down in your pants.
There?
Do the back.
No.
Do the back.
That's nasty.
Do it.
I'm not doing that.
Why not?
Put my hand down.
Because it stinks.
It doesn't stink. Plus, the part that stinks is covered up. Flesh. You don't like spread them and wipe against your couch.
I don't know what you did. Plus, at 46, you may leak.
Don't leak.
I don't know what happens when your body gets that old.
Oh, listen to you.
I don't dribble.
I need to do I. Thank you very much. I'm in very good shape. Dribble.
You might.
I don't dribble.
You're getting dangerously close to 50. 50-year-olds dribble.
No, they don't.
Go look at Bob McNeil's chair. There's dribble stains all over it. And he's wearing clothes.
Yeah. I don't dribble. Didn't mean to be caught. Sorry. I wouldn't think I was doing something wrong. You could have taken a cab or had Trey drive you home.
Did I not say thank you?
Yes. At the door. You're going to let me come in and take a whiz, for God's sake.
I'll let you come in and whiz.
Yes.
You're going to get up and run around in the house. Stick some pants on.
I will. In the future. I will.
Wouldn't have been so bad, but I'd leave the fluorescence on in the kitchen.
Mm-hmm. Sorry.
And fluorescent doesn't flatter your body either.
I've been tanning. Sorry.
You missed some sessions.
No, I didn't.
Where's Everett? Is he out sick today?
Yes.
Mm. I was going to ask him about the lawsuit thing with that illegal alien chick, her family suing the... you know, here's what I'd like to do. I'd like to call Duke University and find out how she got into the hospital and how they said all this was going to happen. Because just think about when you get sick.
Mm-hmm.
Of all the things that we have to go through just to see a doctor, or if you got to go to an emergency room, they want to see all your insurance before you see diddly.
Mm-hmm. You're right. I have no idea.
Unless you're unconscious, vomiting, or bleeding, they want to see everything when you come in. So I want to know, I just like to see the process of, A, they get smuggled into the country. Is that right?
Correct.
They paid somebody to smuggle them into the U.S.
That is correct.
From
Guatemala?
Yeah. All right. So from Guatemala to here.
Mm-hmm.
Now they're in the country illegally. Duke University knows that because they can't produce any documentation.
Correct.
And they go, yeah, we'll do the
we'll put you on
we'll do the transplant.
They were on the list for 3 years.
They were.
Correct. She waited 3 years for this operation. She came in at 14, got it at 17. So the INS had 3 years to go, no.
You're not supposed to be in this country, and we ain't giving you no free stuff. Yes, Dave?
Hey, aren't you being kind of a bitch about J.D. giving you a ride home?
Have you not heard us change topics, Dave?
Yes,
a little notepad. Follow along. Draw pictures if you have to. So, yeah, 3 years to kick them out of the country. You're not supposed to be here. It's illegal. That's why we call you what you are, an illegal alien.
Correct. And I think they've already said, they've set aside 5% of donated body parts, whatever, for immigrants, but not illegal aliens. For like somebody from Europe can come over here and get a heart or something or other. That 5% of the ones donated each year are set aside for people from other countries. And last year we used 4.3 or something.
Well, how did they get it then? Because they're not immigrants. They're illegal.
That I don't know.
Brainiac.
Yes.
Get me that chick from the organ bank, Pam Silvestri. Did you get that?
Yes. Okay.
Then say okay next time.
Okay.
Sometimes it's like talking to a chick. Just communication really is not this difficult. You just say, okay.
It is with him. How many times have you seen him wearing his cowbell?
None.
A, you give him something nice, he don't wear it. Even though he's supposed to. And he runs around the building without it. Comes in the studio like nothing's going on. Hey, here I am. I don't have on my cowbell. I got to need to talk to you about something. Okay.
Just like a chick, you let him get away with it once.
Absolutely. Yeah. And now he's running around. He's in the room in there with O'Malley right now and got his cowbell on. You just wait.
Carrying around an ice box on his back and keeps jacking with me. You're going to whack him after the show Friday, right?
That's the deal.
$100.
Mm-hmm. I got the check.
How are you going to do it?
I'm just going to set him down. He's heard it. He knows.
He thinks it's a bit.
He's already given me his list of contacts last night.
Of guests?
Yes. Just
what did he say when he gave it to him?
Just all the stuff that Dan gave him, he gave to me. He goes, well, I'm getting it Friday here.
Oh, did he really?
Mm-hmm.
Was he pissy about it?
No. Just matter of fact.
So you think he already thinks it's real?
Apparently, he's already turning over his materials to me.
Huh.
So that'll be pretty easy. Well, I'm walking in and go, it wasn't a bit, but have a good weekend.
He's being... He's certainly being a sport about it.
Yes, he is.
Good.
And working out his last week with a smile on his face?
Yes.
I guess that maybe is why he's not carrying a cowbell, because he's...
Because he's on his way out?
Yeah, he's done. He's short-timer.
I could always change my mind. You know how I am.
Mm-hmm.
Ratings came out today. Number one, I'm in a good mood.
Yes, they did.
Everything's lovely. Okay shows so far.
Mm-hmm.
Things could totally swing around 180 degrees between now and Friday.
True.
End of the show. Because you know how happy I am at the end of the show when we've had a good one?
Absolutely.
Friday could come, be 7 o'clock, be all happy. Let's go eat. The big family, group hug. Let's retire together.
You could. I'll wait to cash the check, just in case.
No, he ain't wearing his cowbell. Pamela?
Yes, sir?
It's Pamela Silvestri from the, what is it?
What is it? Southwest Transplant Alliance. Russ, you know by now.
No, I don't. I've never been able to remember it. Say it again. Southwest what?
Southwest Transplant Alliance, yeah. The local life-saving organ donation agency. You should know this.
No, I don't. I know it's Southwest something, and I forget from there on out.
That's all right.
Because you don't have
who we are.
You don't have organ in the name.
We used to have organ in the name. It used to be Southwest Organ Bank, but we changed it.
Why?
Because people thought we had, you know, the kind of organs you play.
No, they didn't.
Yeah, they did. Oh, yeah, they did. Or they would call us and think that we were a bank full of human organs, which, of course, we don't have.
Okay.
You can't store them.
But in your website, like organ.something?
Organ.org. You do have a good memory.
I remember that because it had organ in it. You had to get
there
organ back in there. All right. What's the deal when somebody, now, what do you guys actually do? I forget. Do you actually get the body parts in, or are you the liaison?
We actually go to the hospital and talk to the family when somebody passes away and see if the family is willing to donate their organ.
Now, do you guys keep all the body parts there at the,
Do we keep the body parts?
I don't know where they go.
They go right into the people who need them.
All right, so as soon as they yank them out of one person, they're immediately shipped?
For your audience, I think yank them out is probably okay, but in general, we prefer to say that we recover organs from donors.
I've seen some of the equipment you guys use. You use melon balls.
Huh?
Melon ballers.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And I see how some of these body parts are shipped out.
I mention my name, you get a free base.
Is that it?
Actually, yeah. We carefully put the hearts and lungs and livers and kidneys in coolers, just like you see on TV.
Right.
And take them to the people who are waiting for them in the hospital.
Now,
sometimes I'm Learjet.
JD said that 5% of these organs are set aside for immigrants.
Not set aside. No. But good question. What we do is we transplant up to a maximum of 5% of people that are not American citizens.
I'm guessing that also includes illegal aliens.
Yeah. Uh huh.
Well, how does that happen? They're not supposed to be here. Those are organs meant for Americans.
Yeah, but you know what? A lot of them are here anyway, and that's something organ donation has nothing to do with. And guess what? A lot of them die here, and they become organ donors. So let me ask you this.
Well, it didn't happen with this 17-year-old girl that died. Not only did she get...
I know. Her family didn't donate her organs, and I thought that was a really bad decision. Really bad decision.
Now, I don't even know if they could have because all the medications she'd been on, but still, they had the option, right?
Right. Transplant recipients can donate their organs. So she definitely could have donated organs, not the ones that she got, because those were already taken out of one person and put into her, but she perhaps could have donated her other organs depending on how they were working, but her family wouldn't even considerate.
See, that's the biggest pisser right there, because had it not been of other families going, you know what, my kid or whatever's right. died, take the heart, take the lungs, take whatever right. you need. If it's going to help you and your family along, great. And then these asses totally just bury the whole body.
Yeah, I agree. And who would want to do that? That doesn't make any sense. But most families that we talk to say yes to donation, and a lot of those families are non-American citizens. And we transplant those organs into Americans all the time.
Now, if I'm going to give you my or sign a carry around a card with me or whatever, which, by the way, isn't good enough. If you
right,
carry
you
around an
carry card.
If you do that.
Mm-hmm. You can if you want.
Your
you
family.
Have to.
You got to let me finish.
Maybe. Go ahead. Mm-hmm. It's your show.
Your family can still override that. Even if you're carrying a donor card, your family could say, no, we don't want to do anything. So you got your family's got to know if you're a donor as well. And that's what you want.
Wow, you need to do my job. You're good at this.
Shush. We don't need two smart asses at the same time. All right, Ken, when I decide I'm going to give my body parts away, can I say that they got to go to American citizen?
No, you can't.
I can't designate where they're going to go.
You can designate if you know somebody that's on the waiting list. Like if you died or if somebody in your family died and we were at the hospital asking you for permission,
mm-hmm.
you could say, hey, I know this guy, Joe Smith, and he's on the waiting list. Could you see if my mom's kidney matches him?
And I can't specifically ban non-American people.
No, because if we started doing that, then we would have people going, I only want to donate my organs to white people or black people, or I only want to donate my organs.
Oh, I didn't think about that, too. So no immigrants and no black people.
So is that what your list is?
No.
You just lost some of your audience.
No, I didn't. No, we never do.
Yeah, probably not.
Mm-mm. All right, because J.D. brought this up yesterday. He said his son died and, you know, they harvested the organs and uh-huh. found out they went to an illegal alien. It would have pissed him off. It would piss
really?
Me off, too.
Okay, well, what if his son needed a transplant and the only organ available that day that could save him, or he was going to die?
That's fine.
Came from an illegal, so
that's
you'll
fine.
Take it, but you won't.
Absolutely, because they're illegally, they're breaking the law.
I love the way you think.
No, they're here to be harvested.
They are.
Here to be harvested.
You snuck in, you ran the risk. You don't come into this country, and you know, how do they get on how do they get into Duke University and get all this stuff for free?
They didn't get it for free.
Who paid for it?
Some local guy raised the money. He was all over the news. Local businessman.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I guess that's all right then.
Yeah. You know, somebody was trying to help her out. She was a young, attractive, you know, sweet girl who had a life ahead of her. So I don't.
And this doesn't bother you that people are sneaking into this country and now we got to take care of them too.
Oh, yeah, it does. Trust me. That's one of the reasons we have a lot of problems in our country, not just organ transplant. But if somebody's in this country and they need our health care and they're under that 5% and they've got a way to get on the transplant waiting list, I think their life is just as important as anybody else's. I really do.
I don't.
Human life is human life.
We don't take care. No, you don't get to make no point.
Oh, come on. The Arabs and the Israelis, you know, they don't like each other a whole lot, right?
Right.
But I've seen Israelis die and give organs that were transplanted into Palestinians and vice versa. That's way on a whole other level of understanding humanity than just a non-American versus an American, don't you think?
No.
Ugh, Russ. You're a tough audience.
No, I'm just being contrary because I don't like people sneaking into this country and then all of a sudden we're responsible. And now this family is going to turn around and sue Duke University, regardless of the fact that had she stayed in Guatemala, she would have died down there. At least Duke University gave her the opportunity for a shot at life.
I agree, and I hope the family doesn't sue. They haven't actually said that they're going to.
I bet they do. You know, they will.
I bet they do, too. They really shouldn't because their daughter was going to die without a transplant, period. Most people that need a transplant know they're going to die without it. So if you even get the opportunity, that's an amazing thing. And I know there was a huge medical screw-up here. But, yeah, she got an opportunity that a lot of people don't get.
I still think it's a screw job.
Are you afraid somebody's going to come into the country and take your job? Is that why?
No. I don't like the fact that we're having to take care of people that aren't supposed to be here.
Yeah, we don't even take care of our own yet.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I agree.
How's your husband?
Wow, you and I agree on something. My husband's good. He's still my husband.
Mm.
I know. One of these days I'll change that maybe, but not now.
You remember Pam, don't you?
Yeah,
what
absolutely.
She looks like?
Very hot.
Those piercing eyes?
Yep.
Oh, gosh. I'm getting older. I don't have piercing eyes anymore.
What happened to them?
They're less piercing. I'm old.
You still working out?
Every day.
You're a little hottie.
I love working out, especially when it's really cold like this.
I'd like to get some transplant on her.
All right. If we're going to start talking dirty, I got to go. I represent a company here.
I didn't say anything. It's a transplant. There's your phone. Probably some illegal aliens wanting something. All right. Your website is Oregon.what?
O-R-G. Oregon.org.
All right. Thank you, Pammy.
Call anytime.
All right.
Bye.
She's a little honey.
I know.
I ain't giving nobody anything then. Unless I can specifically say this has to go to an American, I ain't giving them anything.
But you see your point. If you start doing that, then you got to say whites and blacks. And
it's whites and blacks are Americans.
I know, but that's the next step.
If they're supposed to be here, then they can have my organs, which I'm not going to give up anyway. But if I were, then they can have my organs.
What? So you're
they can have stuff I don't. They can have stuff that I don't want.
What if you're dead?
You don't know what medical science is going to come up with in the next 10 years.
It won't matter. You'll be dead and buried.
It doesn't make any difference.
So you're going to be frozen?
Possibly.
Okay. Then if you're going to be frozen, you might need everything. So just hoard it and keep it to yourself. Don't let somebody
else
live.
But you don't know.
So don't let somebody else live that could find a cure for cancer.
And I give a rat's ass they cure cancer if I'm dead. Why? Exactly. I'm keeping my stuff. They can have my spleen. And they can have anything else that I don't necessarily need. You can have my leftovers.
Okay.
It's like looking at a plate. I wasn't going to eat that. You can have that. This other stuff, mine.
So you're not going to donate your heart, your kidneys, your lungs, your eyes?
Uh-uh. Okay. They can have the stuff I don't care about.
I didn't know that about if.
Yeah, you got to tell your family.
My family wouldn't, but.
There's nobody left to tell anybody for you.
Well, my sisters.
Yeah, you got to tell your family because they can override the fact that if they're going to scoop you out.
They wouldn't. My dad gave his retinas. Somebody's seeing today through my father's eyes. That's cool to me. Sorry, didn't mean to get serious.
No, that's all right.
Right?
Yeah. Okay. Nice long break. We'll be back.
More of the Russ Martin Show coming right up.
All right. What is this, Eddie? I forget.
50 Cent.
Oh. See what his music sounds like.
La-da-dee-da.
Go, 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 go.
This is the hit?
That's number 2 on the charts right now.
Go, 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 shawty. It's your birthday. We gon' party like it's your birthday. We gon' sip a card like it's your birthday. And you know.
So. Oh.
He didn't say it?
I hit the delay anyway.
That's the radio edit.
Well, it sure sounded like it. It was cut, but I think they cut like a half a syllable out.
Ah, rock stations get away with playing the Who, where it says, who the F are you?
Okay.
Sound like a pretty blatant F, though.
It wasn't a hard one, but it was there.
You'll find me in the club, bottle full of bub. Mama, I got what you need. You need to fill a bar. I'm in the habit, sex, I ain't in the making love. So come give me a hug, you ain't getting rough. You can find me in the club, bottle full of bub. Mama, I got what you need.
I can't understand this.
I'm in the habit, sex, I ain't in the making love. So come give me a hug.
I'm having sex, not in the making love.
When I pull up out front, you see the Benz on dub. When I roll 20 deep, it's always drama in the club.
Oh, you want to listen to something where you got to focus that hard to understand it.
I'm not sure they listen to it. I think they just background stuff.
I have no idea what he's saying. What is it, Brad?
I just want to ask you why you're playing 50 Cent.
I want to hear what it sounds like.
I thought I was tripping at first, man.
No. I keep hearing about him. I want to hear what his stuff sounds like.
I'm good.
Can you understand it?
Yeah. I understand every word.
No, you can't. It's too fast.
Nah. It go with the music.
What is this song about?
It's just about him, how he living, how he coming up. Don't talk about how he getting shot and you know everything. It's just introducing himself to us.
Oh. All right, thanks.
My show brought me to go. That brought me all my fancy things. My crib, my cars, my clothes, my tools. Look, homie, I just came over.
You can stick a shotgun in my mother's mouth and go, unless you tell me what this song's about, we're going to blow her head off.
Yeah. My mom.
Moved out the hood, now you trying to pull me back, guys. Too much on, get the company in the club. It's on, I'm with my eyes. Bitch, if she's mad, she's gone. Hit the roof on.
What's the other song? Just something else off the album?
It's called Wangsta.
Wangsta?
Yeah. Play on Gangsta.
Is it really?
I mean, that's what he says.
Woo! Yeah. It's 50, a.k.a. Ferrari, F50.
Why do you always have to put their names in it, in all the songs?
Did you just say it?
Yeah.
I missed it.
The very first words, it's 50, was 50.
Yeah, it's 50, a.k.a. Ferrari, F50. Break it down. I got a lot of living to do before I die, and I ain't got time to waste. Let's make it. You say you a gangster.
Did they even wake him up to record this?
I don't think so.
Like he's half asleep.
That or
yo, it's 50.
You ain't a friend of mine. You ain't no kin of mine. What makes you think that I'm gonna run up on you with the nine? We do this all the time.
At least this is easier to understand because he's tired. Maybe this is the end of the album.
Sure that she's so fine. I gotta make her mine. I ask like that. Gotta be one of a kind. I crush him every time. Punch him with every line.
Yeah, Greg.
Yeah, Russ. Yesterday you were giving JD a hard time about doing drugs.
Yeah, he's a stoner. He done the X. Can you do the X?
Yes. One time, half of one pill.
I make any difference?
Yes.
You took illegal drugs. You've ingested them. Doper. So what about it?
Well, you make it sound like everyone in radio does drugs, and you're always making fun of...
Most people in radio do drugs. This is one of the few shows to where nobody's a stoner.
Haven't you ever done drugs?
Mm-mm.
Never.
Nope.
Not once.
Ask me one more time.
Haven't you ever done drugs?
Nope.
Never touched a thing?
Nah, I just now did. It's a good thing you asked me again.
Man.
I just now reached down for my rope clip. I smoked a fatty so big yesterday, we had to use jumper cables to hold it.
No, Russ has never done any kind of drugs at all.
They've been around. Mm-hmm. Everybody, in fact, I was dating I can't take any more of that. I was dating a chick 5-6 years ago.
Right.
And she goes, how do you been in radio so long and not do drugs? It's all around. She's the one that I found out after we broke up.
Yeah.
She gotten into coke. Now she's, you still there, Greg?
Yeah.
I'm not boring you.
No.
Okay. Because I even asked her. She wasn't making enough money to do coke.
Right.
So this is after we'd broken up. Now we're getting our closure.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I'm trying to fly her back down here so I can poke her again.
Right.
But she went up north and checked into some rehab coke clinic. You okay, Greg?
Yeah.
You make it to work okay today?
I made it okay.
Good. Having a good Wednesday?
It's all right.
Okay. Where was I?
She's at a coke clinic.
Oh. I got to go, Greg. Love you, though. Yeah, now she's checked into some coke clinic.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I forgot where I was.
She asked you why you never did drugs. It was all over the place. And
oh, yeah, because I had asked her. I went, where'd you get the money to do coke? If you did it the whole time we dated for over a year, that's a lot of coke. Mm-hmm. And you hid it from me the whole time. So it had to be with somebody, you know, somebody else you were hanging out with.
Right.
You weren't getting the money from me, and you weren't doing it with me. Well, you know, it's because she worked in the commercial department. We call it traffic.
Okay.
But the chicks that keep track of the commercial log of when all the commercials get played and all the other stuff. She goes, it's just all over radio. It's all, you know, the record people and da-da-da. I'm surprised you haven't done it. I don't want to do it. Be my luck. I'll get hooked on it, and that's the last thing I need.
Mm-hmm. You'd like it.
Coke?
Cocaine.
Really?
From what I understand.
How would you know that?
I've talked to a lot of people that are addicted. I watched a buddy of mine who was a lawyer making about $300,000 a year reduce himself to calling me at 3 in the morning and asking for $20. I watched him lose his house. I watched him lose his family. And I watched him lose his business. So I figured, you know what? He's a smart guy. Maybe I shouldn't do that.
What do you want $20 for? You can't buy coke for $20.
He just called in the middle of the night and wanted $20. So I said no. I don't know what you're going to do with it, but no.
And it's funny, I didn't realize this until I went back and looked at it, or looked at the relationship, was she would call me from time to time, go, you know what, our bonus checks didn't come in, and I got like a $350 bonus check, and it's supposed to be here tomorrow. Can I, like, borrow that money today? Well, why don't you just wait till tomorrow? Well, I had some stuff that I wanted to go get. We'll go get it tomorrow.
Yeah.
And at the time, I didn't think anything about it. And a couple of times, I gave her the cash. She eventually paid me back, but it wasn't the next day.
Sure.
Then after, you know, you get away from the relationship and you back up, you look at it and go, all right, what was all this crap?
What it was.
And she was working for a regular radio station. You got paid on a normal basis. It's not like, well, we didn't get our bonus, you know, things this pay period.
Based on sales or something, then we didn't.
And like a mongoloid, I'm talking to her. She's living up in Michigan, mm-hmm. and we're talking back and forth. What is it, Bill?
Hey, you say you've never done drugs, but what about the pot brownies?
I didn't know there was pot in them.
But you did them.
No, I didn't do anything. I ate brownies, and they had something in it.
Did you have something in your system?
No, you said, have I ever done drugs? I haven't done drugs. Eating brownies isn't doing drugs, especially if you don't know anything's in it.
But there were drugs in them, so you...
I didn't know that. I didn't do drugs. I didn't specifically... My intent to eat those brownies was to eat brownies, not to do drugs. I didn't know that had drugs in it. Bill, you're not going to win this one. You're too stupid. You've stepped up. I have an 84 IQ. Don't even try.
Yeah.
So now I'm talking to her. She's in Michigan. And it's like, well, you know, you're out of the... What?
I'm sorry. I have an 84 IQ. Don't even try. I'm sorry. I'm back. She's in Michigan.
Yes. Talk, and now I'm an idiot. It's like, okay, you know, we worked through this, and now that we see what your problem was, the fact that you were on the toot, and you're going through this rehab, you can come down here. God, I'm so stupid. It's one of those moments you look back and you go, I should have just strangled myself when I had a chance.
You didn't know.
Why don't you come down here, and we'll go through it together? I'll walk.
I quit it. If you don't do them, you don't know the behavior.
So then she goes, well, I'll fly down there and we'll talk about it. Okay, I'll send you the money. Stinking bitch never shows up.
Turn the ticket in for cash.
Probably. And probably bought some more toot.
Did she ever call you even?
Oh, yeah, she showed up in town to visit her sister one time. And she calls and leaves a message on the answer machine at home. Hey, it's me. Just stopped by your apartment. You weren't there. Call me back. Hadn't talked to her in 8 months. Never said a word about not coming down here. Finally, she sent me. Oh, I don't know if you were with the show. She sent me the money back.
Oh, she did?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. I don't remember.
Were you with the show then, Eddie? I can't remember when it happened. Okay. I don't know if it was at the Eagle or here, but I got the money back from her. She wanted to hook back up.
Mm. Oh, yeah, that was. Okay. I know what you're talking about. Okay. Yeah, we did. That was when we were doing mornings.
All right.
Here.
Everything's a wash since then. Yep. And like a jackass, I sent her the money thinking, all right, we can make this work.
I can help her.
That'll be the third chick that I've picked, that I've dated, mm-hmm. since I started dating, that's been on coke.
And you haven't known?
Uh-uh. That's the weird thing about it. Obviously, I'm subconsciously picking these chicks for some reason. Yes, Merritt?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
It's Merritt. Did you send CDs to the USS Roosevelt?
Yes, ma'am.
Have you heard from those guys?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
How did you know about that?
I'm Nathan's mother.
One of the guys on the ship?
Yeah.
Oh.
The one that's been emailing you?
Oh, okay. Yes, they've gone out.
They've gone out. I think those guys, they'll really like them. The reserve guys from Carswell are on that air wing now.
Okay.
So they're very familiar with you.
Well, lovely.
And thank you.
Oh, you're more than welcome.
All right. Bye.
All right.
You're making copies of the show and sending them out to where? The USS something or other?
Roosevelt.
Well, that was nice. I didn't know we were doing that. That was very nice. Normally, you hate to make copies of the show. You tell everybody no.
Did so?
You burn CDs of the show and send them out to the U. Well, that's very thoughtful. I just didn't know you did that.
Not me directly.
Who did it?
Eddie.
Oh, Eddie did it. Well, that's still part of the show. Thank you. It's a very cool deal.
I got an email from the guy on the USS Roosevelt.
Yeah.
Said there was a bunch of them from Texas. Could they get copies of the show? Now, before anybody else asks, no. No. No.
Uh-uh. Open the
door. Not a chance. Don't even.
No.
I don't care where you are. I don't care if you can get to us or not. No.
It's another reason I don't like to do stuff like that, because people call up and say thank you.
What's that?
Because now everybody knows that we're making copies of the show and they're going out to the Persian Gulf or wherever these guys are. Actually, he wouldn't tell me. He couldn't.
Yeah.
He just gave me the address, and it had the ship on it, and I guess they know how to find it. He said it would probably take 3 weeks to get there.
Damn. That's very neat.
How many did you send him, Eddie?
Almost 20.
Really?
Yeah.
That'll hold them for a while. But they're going to be out there for a while, because obviously we're going to war.
Yeah, at some level.
What were we on before she called?
The cocaine. The girlfriends you picked three in a row that have done cocaine.
And yeah.
At some subconscious level, you must.
But I didn't, like I said, I didn't know they were doing it at the time, and all three hid it from me. Yes, Laron?
Laron,
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I was going to comment on the 50 Cent and Ja Rule thing that you had going a while ago.
Mm-hmm.
And the deal is with Ja Rule is that he holds a grudge against 50 Cent because one of 50 Cent's friends robbed Ja Rule's best friend.
All right, hold on. Ja Rule robbed 50 Cent's best friend?
No, 50 Cent's friend robbed one of Ja Rule's best friend.
All right, so you got friends of both people robbing each other.
And Ja Rule holds it against 50 Cent,
yeah.
I guess because he's big and he should, I guess bring the guy forward or something like that.
So drop dime on him.
Yeah.
I got it.
So he doesn't. And in the process, they, you know, go back and forth through war, you know, and going at it and arguing. And somehow 50 Cent ended up getting shot. And he got shot 9 times. And that's why he sounds like he's asleep. He had got shot in the face. So now he has a dimple in his face.
Why would anybody want to get into rap? There's a difference between rap and hip-hop, right?
Yeah.
All right.
This is hardcore rap. They call it, I guess, gangster rap.
All right. Is that what he's gangster rap?
Yeah, he's the real deal.
Why would you want to do that and know that you're going to get popped in the face?
I have no idea. But he's real deal, man. He did 6 years in the pen, and he also Golden Glove boxing. He could put some
Yeah,
he could put some down on somebody if he wants.
Mm. Can I ask you something else, since obviously you're a brother of color?
Go ahead.
Why is it when you get a lot of brothers together, you guys can't get along and somebody got to get popped?
I mean, a lot of people are going to be mad when I say this. It's because a lot of people it's like just material things and one and jealousy.
I mean, it's like you got all these people together for that MTV thing.
Right.
It was an urban thing, and fights break out. You have black award ceremonies, and fights break out. I'm not being racist. It just seems like when that happens, you don't see it happen at the country American Country Awards or whatever they have, although you'd wish they would.
Yeah, that's true. But it's just, and then with the freestyle thing, I don't understand why they do that, because they're going to battle, and they're going to say something about this guy. Well, your mom this and your mom, boom, before you know it, they're fighting.
Hmm.
It's crazy, man.
Well,
comment on that.
You need to talk to your brothers and tell everybody to calm down.
I do every weekend, man, but it doesn't work.
Tell them the great wife said, buck up. All right?
All right, man.
Kill Whitey.
All right.
Buck up.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That's what you do. Somebody's all doped up or something, or they're on alcohol or whatever, and they're trying to quit.
Right.
You look at them and go, hey, it's your choice. Stop doing it. Buck up.
I don't even know what that means, but it sounds good.
You ever heard of the term buck up?
Yeah.
Buck up.
I've heard of cowboy up.
Go get them.
Yeah.
Straighten up. Stop doing drugs. Knock it off.
Okay. Stop drinking. Like you have this week.
Shut up. You shut your white ass.
What? What did I say?
You slept on my house naked. You slept on my couch naked.
Yeah.
Just shut up.
You drank
shut. Shut up. Now I owe Lee Harris $100.
I didn't cause you to drink. I think you made me go out to the car on the ice and get it. I was being polite. I poured my drink in my truck. I left it out there. You went, where's the vodka? I went, it's in the truck. Go get it. My drink is full. Mine is not.
Ah.
Sorry. You would have told him anyway. You're honest.
You wait till you're sleeping over at my house again. I'm going to get my $100 out of your ass.
I'm not sleeping in your ass again.
I'm pounding your ass till I get my $100.
Sorry.
Fuck up. You're close.
Can we do news before we break? Do we? Thanks a lot.
Sorry. You would have told him anyway. You're an honest guy. You went a whole day. You did.
I didn't get drunk, though.
That's okay. That's fine. What's wrong? What did I do wrong? What did I do wrong?
So I guess you won't mind if we talk about some of the things that we talked about you enjoy last night.
Yeah, I will mind that.
You would?
Yes.
I'd mind. You got $100?
If you'd like.
Thank you.
Cash.
Give me that check back.
All right.
More of the Russ Martin Show coming right up.
About 4:50. Eddie Boyd is here. J.D. Ryan, Trey Trent home. Dan O'Malley, Gail Lightfoot. All right, we didn't do news, do we?
Nope.
Load that up for me, would you, Eddie? Thank you. All right, you ready to go?
Yep.
Yeah, okay. 4:50, J.D. Ryan's on the new 105.3 FM Talk with News.
Thank you, Russ. News brought to us by Expedia.com and by 24-Hour Fitness. There's one near you. 1-800-204-2400. Videotape salvaged from the wreckage of the Space Shuttle Columbia provides what is likely the final glimpse of the astronauts before the shuttle broke apart. They are seen putting on their gloves. It could be heard casually chatting, unaware of the impending destruction. NASA said the video holds nothing of an investigative value, but it will allow the public to see the astronauts and the inside of the space shuttle minutes before the first signs of trouble. NASA plans to release copies to the media sometime this week. 13 minutes of the tape are preserved despite burning that destroyed the rest of it. California has no law, apparently, against necrophilia.
Why would you need one?
About having sex with dead people?
I know what it means.
Well, there's a reason. I mean, that's pretty sick.
Having sex with dead people?
Yeah. Well, it came to light, especially with this story.
Why?
Well, 4-year-old girl Robin Gillette of Adelanto, California. Earlier this month, she had suffered a seizure and died suddenly, and her body was...
All right, that's nasty.
...abused by the folks that were paid to transport her body to the county coroner.
That's nasty.
Yeah, and Donald Louise Cooper Jr. molested the girl's corpse while his co-worker...
Okay, that's nasty. I get the idea. I get the idea of the story. Thank you. You've been very kind in reading it.
Don't want to...
That should be against the law. But if somebody high...
Still against the law to actually they did get prosecuted under mutilation of human remains.
That's fine. You wouldn't do Faith Hill if you were
she's dead. No,
if she just died.
No,
yes, it's still
that's wrong. It's
no,
dead.
It's not Faith
it's
Hill
against the law.
Faith Hill,
it's sick. Under what circumstance would I find myself in the same room with Faith Hill?
Who knows? I'm just saying she just. All of a sudden, her heart just stops, and before the paramedics get there, and you're sure she's dead, you wouldn't pound a couple?
You called me sick for finishing with someone who passed out.
That is sick.
She's still alive.
That's exactly my point. She had the opportunity to say no. If they're dead, they ain't got a chance to say no. Who's that on the hotline?
It's Dave Chappelle.
What does he want?
He's coming to town. Actually, he just got to town, wanted to say hi.
Is he stoned?
I asked him.
Is he? Dave.
Yeah, man.
You're stoned.
I am not.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not.
Every time you've been on the show, when we were doing mornings, you showed up both times, and you were at a Santana concert.
Who can get stoned in the morning? That was sleepiness.
You showed up out. And then afterwards, after we got off the air, we went over to, I think it was...
That booby castle.
Yeah, that was later. That's right, but we went to Coulter's, and somebody was shoving down the ribs.
Oh, yeah, that was me.
Yeah, thank you. Where are you playing?
Tonight, I think the Majestic.
Is it tonight?
Tomorrow night.
Oh, tomorrow night.
Yeah, I just pulled into town. I was in Albuquerque last night.
So you in town right now?
I'm bragging. Huh?
You in town right now?
Yeah, I'm in town. I just got here.
What are you going to do tonight?
I don't know what's popping, man. I was going to ask you. Last night in Albuquerque, it was like Girls Gone Wild.
Do you want to go to another topless bar?
No, I'm saying, man, wasn't it a topless bar? It was like walking down the street. They were so excited from the concert.
Hmm.
I should have paid a cover charge myself.
Well, where do you want to go tonight? what do you want to do?
I don't know. Is there anything to do besides a topless bar, man?
Well, we can go to eat.
Yeah, that's fun.
You want to do that?
Yeah.
Seriously?
Yeah. Turn the heat up, though. Something a little crazier than eating.
Crazier than eating?
Like if we ate and then went somewhere, where would we go?
Wednesday night.
Dude, I'm white. You come to...
You said white people sleep on Wednesday
you
night?
Can't, yeah.
The Chappelle show is on tonight.
Is it?
9:30, man.
On what?
On Comedy Central.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that.
Yeah, I got a new show.
Well, I didn't know that it already started. I saw the plugs for it.
Oh, it's been going good, man.
You seen the ratings yet?
Yeah, man, we're topping the charts.
Are you really? Are you just lying to me?
No, I'm really, I'm seriously topping the charts.
Oh, by the way, before I forget, nice job in Undercover Brother.
Oh, you like? Oh, thanks, dude.
Love that movie. When the trailers came out, and you can watch them online. I wore that bitch out.
It's crazy, right?
I just love the opening scene with Eddie Griffin holding the orange soda in the Cadillac.
Yeah. What's been popping down here in Dallas?
Nothing. We just got through with an ice storm. You picked the perfect time to get here. Was your flight late or anything?
Nah, I have a tour bus.
Oh, do you really?
Yeah, thank goodness, man, because I heard the airports were messed up.
Well, how are you touring and you're still doing your show on Comedy Central?
Ah, I shot ahead.
How many weeks ahead?
I think I got like 3 weeks.
Hmm.
I'm gonna go back in like, I guess like in a week and finish the season.
How many episodes in a season? Is it 26?
12.
Just 12?
Yeah, but it's hard, man, because it's like me and one other dude is writing all this stuff ourselves. You probably met the dude, that dude Neil. Because I wrote Half Baked with him. We wrote like the first 10 minutes of Half Baked we wrote in Dallas.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, man. But I was playing at improv.
Hold on a second. Does that guy on line 4 say he knows Dave? Or you just want to talk to him? Is he black? All right. Hold on a second, Dave. What is it, Leon?
What up, my brother?
What's up, Leon?
Yo, what up, Dash? I can't believe you talking to this white cracker like you talking to him, like you know him.
Well, I've met him before.
See?
Yeah. Well, I'm going to go see your ass tomorrow night.
You coming?
Yeah, I'll be there.
Good deal.
We have some white women. Oh, by the way, did I tell you Russ Martin? He stank.
That's all right. You make fun of me now. Wait till we show up tomorrow night with German Shepherds.
Oh, you're acting rosy.
Yeah. Laugh now. Wait till tomorrow night.
Holy man. Tomorrow night with German Shepherds. Yeah. I might not show up.
I know how black people are with dogs.
You damn right. Yeah. Especially them dogs.
Yeah.
Oh, Lord! Jeez.
Thank you. What time's the show tomorrow night?
Tomorrow night. I don't know. There's two shows tomorrow night. They're like 8 and 10:30 or something. Majestic.
We'll check in between now and the time we get off. But you're at the Majestic over, was it the one downtown? There's only one, right?
Yeah, there's only one.
Okay.
Only one. And that's the one I'm going to be at.
All right.
We get some tickets and
I'm
we
going
go.
Hit the streets tonight, man. It's nothing to do. There's no clubs.
You know what? We can get a limo and we can hit a bunch of places if you want. There's some black clubs you can go to if you want. I don't care.
I want to see all the people. The black, I got to see the brothers. Must check in with the brothers. Got some white people I want to see.
Do you really?
Yeah,
oh, I know which white people you want to see.
Mm.
Those are the ones that grow it. Am I right?
Russ, you got a hot hand today.
I ain't got nothing.
You got a hot hand.
Seriously, if you want to do something, we can put you on hold and Dan can find out where you're staying. We'll send a limo to pick you up.
All right. I'm going to take, I don't know, man. What time does the city, like, what time do you got to go out by? Is it closed early in Dallas?
I don't know. Why, are you one of those guys that don't start nothing till like 11 or 12?
Yeah, man. You know, New York, is, you just roll out. I roll out 1 in the morning.
No. Ain't nothing happening here that late.
All right. So I got to get cracking by like 9 o'clock.
Yeah, it's ladies' night in a lot of bars, a lot of clubs, Greenville Avenue.
Why don't we take him to Cowboys?
That's the biggest ladies tonight, but I don't think he'd like Cowboys.
You wanna, let's go meet a bunch
Cowboys
of...
Cowboys sounds a little rough. What's that about?
It's just a bunch of hazy white people.
All right.
It's just a big bar where they play cowboy music. They play rock, too, but it's mostly Cowboys.
But we can stop by, see you, homie, with your what do you call it? Hydroponic? Yeah, you're with a hydroponic. They will hit some places.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, it's a... Don't lie, man. You doing any other movies coming up?
Hopefully, man. Once I finish the show, I'm gonna hit the pavement and find that next good movie.
How old are you?
29.
Working his ass off.
Yeah, sure is.
Where's my childhood gone?
How many cities are you hitting?
On this tour, yeah. Like 50. On this leg, I'll finish by the time I get to Denver. Then I'm going to go back, do the show. Then I'm going to hit the Midwest and the East Coast. But now, I'm working west to east this time.
Now, I haven't seen the thing on Comedy Central yet. Because, like I said, I didn't know it was on yet. What's the show about? Half-hour comedy?
Crazy, man. It's like if I could dramatize my act, it would be this show. It's just kind of like a nightclub act come to life.
Is it a sitcom?
No. It's like variety. It's like some masterpiece theater type stuff. Like I'll have short films and clips that I go out and shoot, and then I'll just introduce them for an audience, and then we watch them. You gotta watch it. Tonight we're doing the Real World.
Okay, maybe we can watch it before we go out. What'd you say, 9:30? But that's like on the West Coast, right?
It was 10:30 Eastern time, so
9:30 our time.
Is it
9:30 for you?
All right. Well, I'm gonna put you on hold.
All right,
if
man.
You seriously want to go do something, you let me know.
All right, Majestic, everybody. Don't forget.
I will tell them. We'll find out the times between now. Hold on a second. Trey just handed me.
I should know that stuff.
Well, hang on. Trey just handed me something. Dallas, Majestic, Mr. Al. What is tomorrow?
27th.
Oh, he highlighted it. Okay. 8 o'clock on the 27th. And two shows, 8 o'clock and 10:30.
Right.
Yeah, if we're going to do something, we got to do it tonight.
Right. Exactly.
All right. Let me know, man. Let's make it happen.
All right. I'm going to put you on hold.
All right, now.
Thanks, Sweetie Pants.
Sweetie Pants.
Yeah. Yeah, hold on. He's on the hotline.
That'd be fun.
Brainiac, can you get George to take us out?
Sure.
Go call him now and see if he can take us out about, 9 o'clock. Find out where Dave's staying.
Okay.
I know where he's going to want to hit first.
Mm-hmm. Farmer's Market.
Close. Garden of Wheaton. Thank you. We started news, didn't we?
Yeah, we were kind of into it.
All right.
We can keep going.
Go ahead and continue.
The body of an African-American man who is stowed away in the landing gear of an aircraft bound for Paris fell to earth as the plane came in for landing yesterday. The corpse of the...
Black man fell out of the sky?
Yes. The corpse of the unidentified man was discovered at first light by the owner of the house, which lies directly in the path of the landing to Charles de Gaulle Airport. Illegal immigrants are known regularly to hide in wheel assemblies of international aircraft despite the risks of falling and freezing to death.
Where did he fall?
He fell into a house, basically.
What country?
It was Paris.
France.
Correct. Charles de Gaulle Airport.
Hmm. Sorry, I don't have time for a 911 call.
Maybe we'll discover one.
Excuse me.
Yes.
There's a dead Negro on my roof.
We'll come to get it.
Thank you.
There. Okay. Other daredevils, like the movie superhero currently played by Ben Affleck, is blind. Daredevil.
It's Affleck. There's no T on the end of it. You keep saying T.
Affleck. Better. He's blind, so you might expect that advocates for the blind would be celebrating. You would be wrong. It seems that some of the blind people hate blind superheroes. They don't see the point. No pun intended. Brent Hopkins of the American Foundation for the Blind says, quote, "You tend to get this superhero portrayal, this look at what they've done over and over, when in reality there's a lot of blind people out doing superhuman things. They are normal people who enjoy everyday normal things. To live with this disability, you don't have to be a superhero."
So. Why is it you can't make anybody happy? Everybody's got to piss and moan about something. You make the movie Shallow Hal with the fat chick,
yeah.
And this guy sees a fat chick but sees the inner beauty. Fat people don't like that.
No.
And now you got the blind people that are bitching about this movie.
Mm-hmm. And the one about the barbershop recently.
The black people?
Black people didn't like that.
So you're saying black people are handicapped?
No. No correlation between those two movies.
I was talking about handicapped people.
Oh, sorry. I was just talking about people that... I don't like movies and they don't.
I don't think that's what you meant.
That's exactly what I meant.
I don't think you can go out with us tonight with Dave Chappelle.
Why?
Because.
I like Dave. Okay, I'll go.
Go ahead.
Morbid curiosity has led to a slight bump in sales of Great White compact discs at some area's record stores. Merchants note the aging heavy metal band still sells very few recordings. Sales of the very few Great White discs still in circulation doubled this month from 20 to about 40. Los Angeles-based band whose pyrotechnics are blamed for starting the deadly fire at the station that nightclub sold more than 2 million copies in 1989 of its recording Twice Shy. For some bizarre reason, Stella McCartney has a desire to recycle her own feces in an ecological way. Her human waste passes from the toilet.
Who is that?
Linda, I mean, Paul's wife, Paul McCartney.
Her name's not Stella.
Stella McCartney. I don't know. Thought it was. Well, then why do I have this story?
I don't know. Oh. Well, go ahead and finish it.
A local planning officer. That's the only reason I pulled it. I thought it was interesting. Anyway, she put it into her garden. A local planning officer told Heat magazine, quote, although this method is
I want
smelly,
you to do a drug test tomorrow, too. Something's wrong with you.
I'm not on drugs.
I think in their name, like Heather something?
Heather.
Heather Mills
Heather.
McCartney?
There it is.
Well, who's Stella McCartney?
This is a lady craps in her garden.
So she's not even a celebrity?
I guess not.
Just some random woman that in her own garden. Is that right?
Yes. Although this method is smelly, Stella doesn't have any neighbors, so the only person that's affected is her.
His daughter.
Do what?
Stella McCartney is his daughter.
Well, that's a fascinating story. Where's your cowbell? Well, I don't know who it is, and neither does he either.
Thank you,
all
Kelly.
I know, for all we know, it's some random woman that's going outside and grunting in her own yard for no reason. At least when I do it, it's because I forgot to pay the water bill. Yeah. I'm outside hanging under the cottonwood.
She's got a reason. She's recycling. She thinks her own feces helps her garden. All right. Okay. You want to do the audio that we never did from earlier?
Do we have time, Eddie? Eddie says no.
All right.
Is it fascinating audio?
It's from a CBS 48 Hours thing tonight. And
with Osama? Saddam Hussein?
No. It's from Robert Chambers, the preppy murderer. He's on 48 Hours tonight. The other one's on.
Sounds tempting. I'd love to hear the audio.
Maybe later.
But no time right now.
Okay. Thanks. News brought to us by FHM Magazine. I'm J.D. Ryan on the Talk That Rocks Texas, the new 105.3 FM Talk.
More of the Russ Martin Show coming right up.
What was Dave Chappelle's character in that movie? Was it like Paranoid Brother or
Conspiracy Brother?
Yeah. He was funny in that. Mm-hmm. In fact, I got to go out and get the DVD. It's out on DVD now. All right. I got to do traffic. But is it the real Bad Company?
I was told yes.
You were also told that it was the real Lynyrd Skynyrd. And you already know better now.
I know.
Original lead singer, Bad Company.
I'll have to research that. Yes, I believe that is correct.
So that's going to be Paul Rogers.
Okay. I remember that.
All right. So okay. It's Paul Rogers is coming to town.
That is what I was told.
And it was Larry again at Rustlers. Is that right?
Yes. I don't know if he's coming to Rustlers or Chandelier, though he does both.
Okay. If it's Paul Rogers, yes.
Okay.
Remember the rule. If it's not the original lead singer, I don't want him up here.
Okay.
Short of AC/DC and Van Halen.
So the two.
So if it's Paul, why wouldn't they just say it's Paul Rogers?
I don't know.
Or is it the whole band?
I believe the whole band's coming in.
Because the last time I saw Bad Company, I think was with David Lee Roth. In fact, we went to that concert, didn't we?
Went to David Lee Roth concert? Yes, we did, yes.
Yeah, Paul Rogers and Bad Company opened up for David Lee Roth.
I remember that.
Yeah, no, you were there.
Okay.
So it's Paul Rogers.
That's what I was told.
Yes, he can come on.
Okay.
They're going to play?
Yes, that was the deal.
All right.
You can pick a couple of songs.
I would like...
Would you like to call her yourself and ask?
I'd like Rock and Roll Fantasy.
Okay.
What else do I want, Gail?
I'm not going to tell you because the last time you yelled at me.
I didn't yell at you. Shut up. Bad Company. Rock and Roll Fantasy and Bad Company's too long.
Yeah.
The actual song, Bad Company. Shooting Star. I'll think of something. Okay. All right. 5:13, check on traffic. What do you got, Gailsy?
I got a bunch of stuff, but you've got to watch Dave Chappelle's show. It's the funniest thing. Makes me laugh out loud.
Is it really?
It's great.
He's a funny guy. I like hanging out with him.
God, I'm so jealous. I am so jealous.
You can go with us tonight. He said he wanted a white woman.
Well, this one's married. But his very first show, Tim PVRs it for me so I can watch it because I got to go to bed. But the first show he played had a skit where he was like a KKK leader,
mm-hmm.
had written a lot of books and never appeared in anything other than his hood and his robes. But he didn't know he was black because he's blind. He's been blind all his life. And, oh, gosh, it was hilarious. It's really, really good.
Well, I'll have to tape it tonight.
And the traffic is brought to you by FHM Magazine, Dodge, and American Airlines, and the John Ruiz versus Roy Jones Junior Heavyweight Champion boxing event, which should be a lot better than that other crap they had on. Don't miss Ruiz versus Jones live on pay-per-view. It's this Saturday. Call your local cable or satellite provider to order now. Northbound Central before 635, you got a crash right in the High Five area. Westbound I-30 is reduced to one lane at Ferguson because of all the icy buildup stuff. Eastbound 190 past the Dallas Tollway, there's a wreck in the right lane. Northbound Tollway at Royal, there's a crash. And westbound I-20 and I-45, you've got the off and on ramps all closed because of the ice. And eastbound 20 at Bonnie View, the left lane still blocked by a crash with the backup to Houston School Road. New Allivert is non-drowsy allergy medicine that starts dissolving the instant it touches your tongue. So you can take Allivert right when you need it, wherever you are. Huh. Oh. Oh, got me. I'm Gail Lightfoot with traffic on the new 105.3 FM Talk, the talk that rocks Texas.
Thank you, Gail. Going to be cold again tonight, so whatever is wet will freeze over. Remember that if you're driving. Then 36 tomorrow, then some drizzle by Friday. It's 27 now at the talk that rocks Texas, the new 105.3 FM Talk.
You like making love? Is that what you said?
Yeah. That's one of them.
Yeah. That, rock and roll fantasy, feel like making love.
Okay.
What else did they have?
Well, they had a ton. I mean, Sweet Little Sister.
Oh, you know what? He can also do some stuff for free. He can do All Right Now.
Yeah.
Because he was the lead singer for free.
Right. I'm just looking at the list.
That's what I'd like. I'd like All Right Now, rock and roll fantasy, and feel like making love.
Okay.
And it's Paul Rogers.
He didn't say the word exactly. What he said was it's the lead singer from Bad Company.
That's Paul Rogers.
We had a very brief conversation. I went, okay, you're sure? Because you don't want to give me trouble. He laughed and went, yes, I'm sure.
So, he also said it was originally, he said we had Leonard Skinner coming.
Yes.
You want his number?
Yes.
Write it down.
What is it, Robert?
What gives you the right? You were making fun of.
What are you mad about, Robert?
It just pissed me off.
Some days you call up, you're happy. Some days you call up, you're pissed off.
Why can't you agree with everything you say?
Why can't you just like me for me?
I do, but
no,
I
don't
agree with everything you say.
Well, don't try and change me.
I'm not trying to change
you. Well, all right, what do you
mean? What gives you the right? I just want to know what gives you the right to say that people like Phil Spector and Michael Jackson are freaks.
They are.
Okay, granted, but what gives you the right to say that?
Because I ain't never molested a kid or shot nobody in my house.
Let's go.
I came dangerously close last night when JD was standing naked in front of my refrigerator.
You never shot anybody in your house?
No.
I seem to recall a story
that
about
that. Sounded really gay because you didn't explain the story.
I ain't explaining the story. If you just turn the radio on, figure it out for yourself. Let them figure out why you're standing in front of my refrigerator naked.
But I do seem to recall a story about a reflection one day.
I shot a mirror.
Yeah.
All right.
And I seem to recall somebody...
We also had cops call up and say they've been clearing houses before and come across a mirror in a room and they shot it. So I ain't the only one.
But let's go back over this.
All right.
You have two cars from TV shows.
Uh-huh.
One of which is a cartoon, for God's sake.
Got it.
The car never existed.
Got it.
Okay? You own a Batman costume.
So, a lot of people do.
True.
Yes.
No, they don't.
Yes, they do.
Who owns Batman costumes?
It's just a Halloween Batman costume. Shut up.
You date porn stars.
Okay.
Okay, given that's cool. But you date porn stars.
All right.
You are a total recluse.
All right.
You never go out of the house.
Excuse me, that doesn't make me a freak where I'm shooting people just for being in my house. And I certainly don't have Never Neverland going on in my backyard. I'm working on it.
You're working on it. But what gives you the right to say these guys are freaks?
They are freaks. And you know what? I was going to ask you if you want to go hang out with us with Dave Chappelle tonight, but since I'm a freak, obviously you don't want to be with me.
I wish I could. Too far away.
But
so you're saying
you
I'm wait a minute. So you're saying I'm as big of a freak as those guys?
You're not as big of a freak as those guys, because you can look at Michael Jackson and look at the regression from the surgeries that he's had.
Yeah,
he's not even human anymore.
No, he's not. He really should. You know what? If you really hit the, had the vitiligo and you're turning white, go ahead. If you're gonna bleach yourself, that's fine. But the other plastic surgeries, that's just weird. His hair, I don't got a clue. Phil Spector, he's a nut.
All he was a recluse who got careless or got stupid.
I shoot anybody.
Again,
thank
computer
you.
Reflection.
First of all, the computer locked up on me after I'd been working on something for 45 minutes. The computer asked for it. It vexed me. It invited me to shoot it. It would be rude for me not to accept.
Correct.
And the mirror. You have a locust in your own yard.
You got your nail one? You really don't need a firearm to clear the front yard of vermin.
No.
It was the side yard of the house. And you know what? You know too much about the show. And first of all, I had those little holes burrowed into my dirt all over the backyard. I didn't know what they were. Could have been snakes. Could have been some kind of varmint. Could have been whatever.
But you still don't go after it with a Glock.
Did I hit it?
You said you did.
Thank you. Yeah. I go outside and I see it backing out. This is the first time I'd actually seen what was burrowing those holes. Because in my first house, I'd never seen this crap before. And I see it backing out. Michelle starts screaming, Jesus! And it had just backed its ass out of that hole. And it starts, it's not completely out. It just, you know, its butt is out.
Yeah.
And that's when I whacked it. It looked like he was about to take flight.
Discharging a firearm inside the city limits is against the law.
My own property. I was defending myself. I didn't know what that thing was going to do to me. It was a wild animal.
It was.
For all I know, a wildebeest was coming out at me.
It wasn't a wild animal. It was an insect.
I didn't know what. I didn't even see all of it. That son of a bitch was that big. When it was, first of all, the holes were that big.
I got you.
Okay. They looked just like crawdad holes. Because all the stuff is burrowed out.
He's not going to attack you.
I didn't know what it was going to do. All I know is we go out to the side of the house and she starts screaming. She starts screaming, shoot it, shoot it. I didn't know. I didn't know how many were going to come out. Could have been a clump of them.
Wouldn't want to be your neighbor. You had gunfire in that house, outside that house.
I believe I hit it with three shots.
Three shots.
I believe.
Okay.
The only thing I was worried about was hitting the underground sprinkler system.
Also had your neighbor's door blown in by someone with a gun because she locked herself out.
No, that wasn't that gun. Yeah. Marty the cop did that.
Yeah.
He did it with a gun.
Oh, I thought he kicked it in?
No, he busted out the window with his flashlight.
Oh, okay.
Then he shot it. I forget how he got in. That was 3 years ago.
Anyway.
I don't think we necessarily talked about him shooting.
Okay. Sorry. Thought we did on the air.
That would be against.
Okay. Bad.
I don't remember what we did. Oh, and then my neighbors come down today. Is this Larry's phone number?
Yeah. It's Larry's number.
I got dial one?
Yes.
My neighbors come down and they're bitching at me, one of them, because I'm using the water hose to melt the ice on my driveway so I can get out.
Well, it's going to refreeze.
It's not going to refreeze.
It's going to be 21 degrees tonight.
It is not going to be 21. Where'd you get that effing forecast?
Right here.
We're sorry. You
got the wrong one. It's not going to be 21 tonight.
Okay. I'm just looking at weather.com.
Why don't you try one of the local ones?
Oh, you put in a...
Why don't you try Chesner?
Okay. I'll call Chesner.
And plus, have you seen the streets now? First of all, the water's going to drain off.
It's going to get cold when the...
The water's going to drain off.
Okay.
Melts the ice, drains off. You ever notice how driveways are sloped?
Right.
You know why?
Mm-mm.
Water drain off.
Okay.
So water's draining all the way down the alley. Everything's starting to mush. He comes down and goes, your water's going down the alley. You're welcome. Did you skip science class? Running water? Melting ice? Blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
Winter thaw? Well, it's going to refreeze. No, it's not going to refreeze. Get off my land. I just dialed one. I didn't get his number.
I tried just without one then. All right. Finfrock says 26.
Call Chesner.
Okay.
Hey.
Larry.
Yes.
It's Russ Martin at KYNG.
Hey, Russ. How are you?
Good. How was Lenny Skynyrd last weekend?
Actually, it was very good, man.
How was the crowd?
We had a great turnout.
People were standing out in the rain and the drizzle. They waited to see the show. They really just kind of popped in, and we had a great night. We should have been there.
Yeah, I would have been if Leonard Skinner had been there. Yeah, whatever. All right, so what's the deal with Bad Company? Who's coming?
Brian Howe.
Could you hold on just a second?
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. All he said to me was, it's lead singer of Bad Company.
Did you ask? Hold on.
I did not ask.
Larry.
Yo.
Did JD say, is it the original lead singer for Bad Company?
Well, man.
What did JD ask?
He said, you know, who's going to be the singer? I said, Brian Howe.
Did he actually tell you his name?
He may have. At the moment, I don't remember. Right, we were on a quick call. I didn't remember.
Are you and Trey sharing the same gas can that you're snorting gas out of?
No.
After this big fiasco with Leonard Skinner, granted, I'm sure it was a lovely concert, and I'm sure that Larry had a lovely crowd out in the middle of Terrell.
Right.
But it wasn't the Leonard Skinner that I was looking for. Now you got Brian Howe. I got no idea who that is. He's the lead singer. How long has he been with Bad Company?
I don't really know, Russ. I've been doing the country scene for a long time and just kind of changing gears.
Larry, do you check into anything when you book these? How do you book these people?
I go through an agency.
And the agency goes, hey, we got Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Chan. You want
Well, no, they're saying, you know, they've got this act. They explain, you know, it's the Bad Company act. They've got Brian Howe, who was the lead singer for Bad Company, who's, you know, running the show. He's going to be the main man out there singing the show, handling the show.
Yes.
And that's the way we promote it.
I've never heard of Brian Howe.
Well, he's got a website, and I think J.D. might have looked it up on the Internet.
Hold on, let me look.
Do you? When are they supposed to be there?
They're going to be at Rustler's on the 14th and at the Chandelier on the 15th.
Of March.
Of March, correct.
If you get Paul Rogers, we're interested.
Well, I'll see what I can do about getting Paul then. It might have to be another time, but it certainly won't be the 14th and the 15th because I've already basically booked Brian Howe.
Well, you certainly don't want to,
It says on the Internet right here, BrianHowe.com, former lead singer for Bad Company, pictures, discography, bio, and more.
I've never heard of Brian Howe before in my life.
Yeah, there's a...
You know what? I sang with Loverboy, but today I'm on my website.
It says former lead singer.
Oh. All right, well... we'll think about it and let you know.
Oh, that's cool. Hey, I appreciate the phone call.
Okay, thank you, Larry.
Have a great day, Russ.
All right. Maybe Paul quit for a while and Brian stepped in, and then Paul came back with the band. Maybe that does happen sometimes.
I've never heard of Brian Howe, ever.
Okay.
And he certainly didn't do all the hits with Bad Company.
Probably not.
You've lost your mind.
That's why I asked you. I didn't book him.
I don't want any more of your knockoff bands. Like I told you yesterday.
I know. ACDC.
No Pink Lloyds.
No. No. I won't do that.
No Bob Jovies.
I won't do it. I won't. Promise.
And most of all.
Yes.
No 38 Special Ed. Real bands,
yes.
Real singers.
Okay.
You know when we had Bon Jovi?
Right.
You knew it was Bon Jovi, right?
Yes.
You didn't have to ask.
No, we didn't, because John was here.
John Bon Jovi sat right here.
Right.
Matchbox 20?
Right.
Rob Thomas was over here. Adam Gaynor was over here.
I remember that.
That was really Matchbox 20. Def Leppard?
Mm-hmm.
Had them.
They were here.
Leonard Skinner?
Mm-hmm.
Never met him. You were the music director at the Eagle for music director?
3 years.
You would know who the lead singer of Bad Company
it was
is.
Just a quick phone call. He said, you want the lead singer of Bad Company? I went, it's the guy. He goes, yeah. I went, okay.
Break.
I'll ask Russ.
Hold on a second. Yes, Damon?
Hey, Brian Howe was the lead singer of Bad Company in the early 90s, late 80s. There's no smoke without a fire. If you needed somebody... how about that? Those are top 10 hits.
No, they weren't.
Yeah, they were.
I've never heard any of those songs.
How about that?
Yeah.
No smoke without a fire.
Somebody else emailed.
He's got a great voice. Check it out.
Ask me again. What was the song?
No smoke without a fire?
Why didn't you say that? I never heard of him.
Late 80s, early 90s.
Okay. All right, thank you. What are you looking at?
Somebody else emailed, said he sang Holy Water for Bad Company.
I don't remember that one either.
Okay.
No Sam Halen.
Okay. I won't book him. .38 Special Ed would be funny to watch. I don't care where they're playing. I'd like to watch that.
Get a bunch of tards and give them equipment.
Right.
Ooh. Yeah. All right. We'll be back.
More of the Russ Martin Show. Woo! Coming right up.
As far as I know, Trey's calling George.
Great.
The Ultimate Limousines. See if there's a limo available. Somebody emailed and said that was this place up off Beltline? The big city streets?
Times Square now. It's called Times Square.
Yeah. So they were having some kind of Mardi Gras thing.
Okay. Oh, that's right. They have a big ladies' night deal on Wednesdays. I forgot about that. We just don't go up that way. Forgot.
So we could take the limo over there. Mm-hmm. Plus, it's what, 4 or 5 clubs?
It's 5 clubs.
Is it really?
Uh-huh.
So you can check with Dave and see if he wants to go over there. All right. Yeah, Michael?
Hey, why don't y'all ever been to Gators for Mardi Gras?
No.
Well, here's my main question.
Do
you ever had
AC/DC
in the studio?
It was Christmas of 97.
I figured if he could pull Loverboy's chain in the studio, he could get AC/DC.
Yeah, I had Brian and Angus.
Really? What did you think about it? Did you get all excited and everything?
Yeah, it was all week. Well, they were cool guys. They just sit around and we talk. I think they were around for a couple hours.
Did you pull your pants down?
Yes, absolutely.
You did?
Yes.
Problem, huh?
Mm-hmm. All right. Showed him my stinky. I'm funny. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Mm. I think we've had Brian on a few times. Bad Company. Yeah, Chad.
He did sing.
JD is becoming a chimp on a leash.
No, he did sing with Bad Company.
Well, no, but who cares about that guy?
Well,
we care about Paul Rogers.
Yeah, that's cool. I'm telling you.
Most people who aren't into rock, yeah, they know that Bad Company, that Paul Rogers was the lead singer for Bad Company. You don't have to be a rock aficionado to know that.
Trey is really dumbing him down.
I knew that.
Yeah, you're sniffing the fumes with Trey.
I'm not.
They'll stop. Stop.
Trey is a flippant to gibberet.
Yeah. Stop sniffing gas.
I'm not sniffing gas.
Be bigger than the show.
I am.
Buck up.
Got it.
Don't be stupid.
That's why I asked you.
No. You said Bad Company was coming, and do I want them?
That's all I could. I can only repeat what I was told.
After the big fiasco with Lynyrd Skynyrd, it seems like that'd be the first thing out of your mouth. Is it Paul Rogers? Yeah. Brian Howell. Yes, Frank.
Hey, Russ. I was talking to my girlfriend after listening to y'all's woman's fantasy deal on what would be her fantasy.
Yes.
Got her a little drunk, and she told me that she wanted 2 brothers. I mean, what the hell am I supposed to do with that?
Get her a couple of brothers.
Well, I don't know if I'd be very comfortable with that.
Does she want to know them? Or
I
just 2 random brothers?
Because really
I can tell you how to get 2 random brothers.
Why?
Huh?
How would I get 2 random brothers?
Let her loose in a certain neighborhood.
No. Let it.
Well, I'm sure she wouldn't want to be, like, just raped, no. But she wanted...
So she really, she told you that? She wanted 2 brothers just to come take her?
Yes.
Did she want you in the mix, too?
No.
Just the 2 brothers?
Just the 2 brothers.
Does she want you to watch?
I don't think so. She didn't mention that. I don't think I could.
Why not?
Well, it'd be kind of hard watching...
Would you watch 2 white guys do it?
No.
Okay. So either way, it doesn't matter the color, then?
No, not really. I just...
Does it wig you out that it would be 2 black guys?
Yeah.
Why is that?
Well, I'm not prejudiced or nothing. It just doesn't seem right.
Why does it not seem right?
Well, I mean, I figured everyone just stays where they need to stay.
Mm. Oh, hold on. Look at here. We have a volunteer on the phone.
That was number 3 on the fantasy list.
What was?
Having a
black guy?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Hey, Woodrow.
Hey, what's up, man?
Nothing, brother. Oops. You going to volunteer?
Hey, I volunteer. I volunteer my services.
get a little in-man in her life.
Little what?
A little in-man, nigga man on her. Put some of this black, some of this soul, brother. If she wants some soul pole, I can give it to her. I got enough for two people.
I don't think she needs any chocolate myself.
Hey.
Woodrow's ready to give it to her, and he's the superhero. He's...
in-man.
You can say it. You're black. You can say Woodrow.
Hey. Hey. If she really want to do this, we can do this dang thing.
Let him have some, Frank. Let him have some of your woman. Let Woodrow have some of your white woman.
Let me have some of the, Miss Beautiful,
Woodrow, have you ever had a white woman?
Yeah, I done had a couple of white women.
How were they? Did you know?
They really know how to go downtown. Put it like that, Put their face in the place.
That's good.
And, she can put her face in my place.
And do they scream loud when you jump out of the bushes?
Oh, yeah. What? Hey, just name the time and the place. Me and my homeboys can be over there. We can run that train real smooth.
Look at there, Frank. Woodrow and his posse will pull a train on your woman.
No, I'm wanting to know how to kind of convince her she doesn't need that.
Oh, I think this would be great. I've seen Woodrow.
Let me try to convince her that she do need it.
Woodrow's a superhero. He can give it to her.
Yeah.
I just don't feel right about it. I was just wondering, I wouldn't expect him volunteers.
Woodrow, I've seen Woodrow, he's a good looking guy, just when they come over, screw some stuff down.
Yeah, because I get it. Hey, check this out.
Mm-hmm.
You seen that movie, Undercover Brother?
Yeah.
Y'all can have your own, we can make our own Undercover Brother at the house.
Yeah. Hey, Woodrow, you want to go with us tonight with Dave Chappelle?
Hell yeah.
You want to go?
I want to go.
All right.
Kind of cold outside.
That'd be all right. We get a limo. Then Woodrow and his other brothers can come bang your girlfriend.
Yeah, I get my old boy.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Won't that be fun? Tell her you've lined up some black men to come satisfy her, quench her pelvic fire.
Well, I'll see what she says about that.
All right.
Already.
All right. There you go. All right, Woodrow. Call us later.
All right, dear.
All right.
Sometimes fantasies are better left fantasies.
Why?
They just are. Sometimes things are better left as just, that would be a fun little dream sequence.
I'm not the one that brought it up. I'm just fulfilling fantasies. That's my job.
Yeah.
Guy calls in. My woman wants to be taken by two black men. Woodrow calls up, fulfills the order.
Okay.
You ever had a black woman?
Nope, never have. Made out with one once.
Did you?
Mm-hmm.
What happened?
Nothing.
She what?
We just didn't consummate the deal. We just played, got cans, and had a good time.
Did you get her wet?
Mm-hmm.
Did she smell funny?
No. God. Go ahead. No.
Where'd you meet her?
She was actually a roommate of a friend of mine. In town for... She traveled, and she was in town for about a week.
What year was this?
This was shortly after my divorce. So, 92?
So, you guys just hook up and made out? Did you take her out someplace?
We
take her out in public?
We went to dinner, yeah. It wasn't a dating situation. We were just friends. And we were on the couch one night at this person's house.
Uh-huh.
It led to another.
Where'd you take her?
When we ate? I don't even remember. We go out as a group.
Oh, it wasn't just you and her?
I don't remember if she and I ever went out together.
You would remember if you went out one time on a date with a black woman, because you know how people point.
I wouldn't have paid attention. She's really cool. She's a nice person. We never dated.
I took out Kimberly one time when I was working over for the Eagle.
Mm-hmm.
Black chick.
I remember.
We went over to Papacito's.
Mm-hmm.
We sat in an area where nobody could see us. And if somebody would look, I'd make her stand up, look like she was taking my order.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
I know better. You wouldn't do that.
Mm-hmm.
No.
All right, fine. Yeah, Jason?
Hey, yeah, Russ, do you want to meet Joe from Blue's Clues? Because the traveling show's coming through again.
We had our chance with Steve.
Yeah, well.
JD blew that one.
Yeah, I think this is a different one, too. So if he tells you, he gets Joe.
Is Joe the new host?
Joe is Steve's brother, I think.
This is a traveling Joe.
Oh, so it's not even the original Joe.
No, it's not the good Joe, even.
No, we don't want him.
Okay.
Yeah, we've had Leonard Skinner. We don't need anybody else.
Oh, okay.
We're covered. Thank
all
you.
All right, bye-bye.
When we do news last? About 4:50? You got another newscast?
Yes, I do, actually.
how come you guys didn't hook up again?
She left town. And I started dating that D woman.
Oh. How come she left town?
She traveled for her job.
She a stewardess?
No, she's actually in sales. She only came in about once a month. That's why she was a roommate of a friend. She just needed a room for about a week, a month. It was a weird deal. Very nice girl.
Bill good?
Very.
Big onion?
Not big.
Stinky finger? Did you? Play with the cans? Did she touch it? Did she? Good for you. You wear your hood?
I have a hood. No. I'm not prejudiced.
Okay. And here we go. 550. J.D. Ryan's on the new 105.3 FM Talk with News.
Thank you, Russ. News brought to us by 24-Hour Fitness. There's one near you at 1-800-204-2400. North Korea urged its people and armed forces to be ready for war today, saying it could be the U.S. military's next target after Iraq. The communist government accuses the United States of planning to send reinforcements into its coastal waters as precursor to of an invasion. Washington has repeatedly said it wants a peaceful solution to the standoff over North Korea's nuclear activity, but says it leaves all options open. Dutch brewer Heineken reported, of course, the airlines are talking about going bankrupt, but Heineken up 11.2% increase in profits from the ordinary operations in 2002, and it forecasts further profits in 2003. The world's second biggest beer maker by revenue reported that profits after tax on ordinary operations this year was $855.8 million. From AskMen.com, why would a single or even attached woman chase after a married man when she knows that he's attached to another woman? Easy, according to AskMen.com. It starts off because, as is the human condition, the food on someone else's plate always looks and sometimes even tastes better than what you ordered.
But I tell you.
About what?
Having somebody that's married.
Well, I've done it too. I made that mistake.
No, you didn't make that mistake. You specifically chose one of your neighbors, and you knew he was going to be out of town. You went over there, and you got you some forbidden poon.
According to a study conducted by the University
of... At least I don't go to the neighbor's house. Do you actually bang his wife in his house? I don't think I've ever asked that.
No. She came to my house.
Oh, she did?
Right.
But you're still married, though, right?
Yeah.
Oh, I remember where you guys banged.
Yes.
Did you not want me to say?
I'd rather you not, but it's up to you. Huh? It's not a big secret.
Nobody's going to figure it out, Andy.
Let's just not.
Okay. It's your hot tub. You say what you want.
Yeah, according to the study, University of Louisville, many women tend to engage in something the study refers to as mate copying. In other words, such women tend to believe that if another woman is after a man or with a man, there must be something he possesses that is worthy of pursuit. Maybe it's because these women love a challenge, drama, no strings, or even simply the thrill of the sin. Whatever the case, many a woman has revealed that sex with an attached man is usually incredible.
It is. Of course, I'm talking about a married woman.
I understand. I understand what you're saying. I guess just because it's
you're not supposed to have them.
It's forbidden and naughty, and it's normally very passionate. And
yes, it is.
Feeling very.
Because you got, and the great thing is, they know you're not looking for a relationship, or most of them know that.
Mm-hmm. I know.
They're out of control when they're giving it to you. Because chances are what you're doing is not what her husband's been doing for the past 6-7 years.
Exactly. That was my situation.
So she came back to your house?
And yes, and I once in her house.
You banged her in her house? In her husband's bed?
No. In the shower.
How rude.
Why is that rude? I tell you, ruder than what you do.
Excuse me, I bang them in my own house. They come to me.
You continue to do it. I did.
They come to me. It don't make any difference. You did your neighbor. You're even a friend of this person.
How does that make a difference? It was a mistake.
It's not like you're banging somebody's wife and you don't know the husband. You didn't want both. At least the chicks I'm banging, I don't know their husbands.
Oh, that makes it okay.
Makes it okay for me. And they're coming to my house. Absolutely. Like I said before, I'm not the one committing adultery. I'm just witnessing it.
Okay.
You were married. She was married. Yes. It'd be sick to be in the same room with you.
Okay. When Alice in Chains lead singer Layne Staley died almost a year ago, all we heard was his smack.
Smack addiction.
Little black flies.
Finally taking its toll. Well, we had no clue how miserable his final days were.
There's
a new book out called Blaine Staley, Angry Chair, a look inside the heart and soul of an incredible musician that contains the last interview Blaine Staley did less than 3 months before he died from an overdose of cocaine and heroin.
He turned to moosh when he was laying there, didn't he?
Yeah, he laid there for, I think they said 7 to 10 days, and he turned into kind of black moosh.
That's because the little black angels that came down to watch over him helped him turn to moosh. That's what they do.
Yes.
Well, you can't get the good angels.
Yeah.
They send the little black ones down to keep turn you to moosh.
No, they don't.
Yes, they do. They come down, they look at the dead body, and they go, boom.
In that interview, Staley said he knew his time was up. Quote, I know I'm dying. I'm not doing well. This effing drug use is like the insulin a diabetic needs to survive. I'm not using drugs to get high like many people think. I know I made a big mistake when I started using this stuff.
This effing stuff?
Yeah, not the word he used. It's a very difficult thing to explain. My liver is not functioning. I'm throwing up all the time, and I'm pooping in my pants.
Yeah. That's what attracts the little black angels.
The pain is more than you can handle. It's the worst pain in the world. Dope, sick, hurts the entire body. I know I'm near death. I did crack and heroin for years. I never wanted to end my life this way. I know I don't have a chance. It's too late. It just goes on and on.
Where were these notes? Where'd they find these?
These were, this doesn't say where he found them. It was an interview. It was an interview. This wasn't notes. This was an interview that he did for a magazine 3 months before he died.
How come we never heard of that until just now?
I don't know.
That should have been out a long time ago. Let people know what the hell drugs do to you.
Yeah. It's too late. Don't try to contact anyone in Alice in Chains. They are not my friends. Turns out his dad disappeared on him when he was a kid. Then when he made a lot of money, his dad, who also happened to be a heroin addict, who supposedly cleaned himself up, came back into his life, started borrowing money and doing drugs with him, and that just took him down.
So it was his dad's fault?
No, it was his dad's fault, but it doesn't help when you have someone around you.
Is that your phone? Answer it. Answer it.
Okay. I will. Hey, Scott. What's up? Scott Chesner. Oh, you weren't at work? Okay.
Where is he now? Does he know you're on the air?
Right now. You know, we're on the air right now. You and I aren't, but I am. Okay. Can you want to call in and talk about the weather, or can you?
What's he wearing?
Okay. Well, can we call you on your cell and just
ask him if he's naked?
Okay.
Ask him if he's naked. Is he naked?
It's in my caller ID.
Is he naked?
All right. Bye.
What's he doing?
Are you naked? He's not naked. You want to call him? You told me with the weather to get a hold of him.
Yeah. Day and a half ago. Where's he been?
He wasn't at work yesterday. He didn't get the message.
Couldn't make it in?
He can make it in.
One of the worst weather days that we've had in the last 24 years, and he couldn't make it in?
He was off. He wasn't scheduled. They have 5 weather people. You want to call him?
Why is your phone on?
Feel free. Don't know.
We're going to have a show meeting today.
Okay.
You, me, and Trey. Nice big meeting. Eddie, I want you there too.
Oh, no.
Bring your truck.
A Southeast Texas man accused of forcing his stepson to sleep in a doghouse as a form of discipline has agreed to accept the same punishment in a plea deal with prosecutors. Curtis Robin Sr. of Vider was indicted on charges of injury to a child and faced up to 10 years in prison if convicted, but he accepted this deal instead. He allegedly whipped his 11-year-old stepson with a car antenna, made him sleep in a doghouse for several days, and possibly a week as punishment. Also made him chop wood for hours and hours. Now he will get to sleep in a doghouse for 30 days.
Hold on a second. Yeah, Jeff?
Hey, is Scott Chesner the one with the fake ear?
Yes.
No.
Yes, he is.
No, he's not.
Quit it. Yes, he is.
Well, then we're not going to call him. All right.
Why not?
Because you can't insult somebody and then ask him to do you a favor.
No, I just saw him in Cadillacs one night in Fort Worth in a stockyard.
He didn't have his ear on, did he? Because sometimes he goes out without it.
He does not.
Yes, he does.
Oh. Yes. Thanks, man.
All right.
Not true. You want the audio?
I've seen him take it off.
No, you haven't.
Yes, I have.
All right. I'm not giving you the number then.
Give me the number.
Insulting my friend.
No. I'm not. Give me the phone number.
I turned the phone off.
Turn the phone back on.
You told me to turn it off.
I forget. I know we've asked him this before, and I forgot what he said.
Don't even.
Is it fake?
No.
Well, why come I can't ask him?
Because that's
if it ain't fake, how come I can't ask him?
That's insulting.
How come I can't ask him if it ain't fake?
It's insulting.
Ask me if my left arm is fake.
No.
Ask me.
Is your left arm fake?
No.
Okay.
Am I offended?
No.
Okay. Why would he be offended? Is it fake?
No.
Is it fake?
No.
I'll turn the mics off.
it's real. You're not going to put it on me again. Do you care about this audio? It's just the CBS.
I want to know if his ear is fake.
No, it's not. Not going to come on and be insulted by
that's
you.
Not going to be insulting.
That is insulting.
I just want to know if it's fake.
That's insulting.
Why?
Just because it is.
I think I saw him take it off once.
You never did.
I did.
Mm-mm.
Okay.
All right. I suppose that's news and information there. Brought to us by 24 Hour Fitness. I'm J.D. Ryan on the Talk That Rocks Texas, the new 105.3 FM Talk.
Yeah!
More of the Russ Martin Show coming right up.
Ready to go, Gail?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We can make this the last one, and then you can go home.
Okay, thank you.
All right, what do you got?
Well, I've got southbound 635 shut down at I-20 due to ice, one of the few spots now, along with I-20 around I-45. Now, westbound I-30 at Lake Ray Hubbard, you can get through, but it's just really, really rough and unpleasant. It's going to take a while. Northbound 75 Central past Mid-Park, almost to Spring Valley. You've got the two left lanes blocked by a crash. In Irving, westbound 183 at Belt Line, there's a lane blocked by a disabled car or something. Eastbound I-30, the old turnpike at Beltline in Grand Prairie. We've gotten reports of an accident. Don't know which lanes are blocked at that location, though. Just be careful tonight and enjoy tomorrow not being horrible. I'm Gail Lightfoot, and that is traffic on the new 105.3 FM Talk, the Talk that Rocks Texas.
All right, here we go. We got mid-20s for the low tonight, so some refreezing on the roads, then cloudy and 36 tomorrow. Some drizzle by Friday. We have 30 degrees now at the Talk That Rocks Texas, the new 105.3 FM Talk.
Yes, Chris?
Hey, what's going on, Russ?
Mm.
Man, I mean, ear jokes are cool and everything. The old boy's got big ears. But hell, I only got one.
You only got one ear?
Uh-huh.
Where's your other ear?
Well, the one I've taught listening to you through.
I don't get it. What?
I was born with a birth defect. I was born with one ear. I've had 13 surgeries just to reconstruct one side.
They make one? What are they making out of?
Well, skin graft.
Oh. What does it look like? Does it look real?
No.
What does it look like? You get a baby ear?
It's not even a baby ear.
How big is it?
Well, it's hard to describe. It's closed up. You can't put a pencil behind it or anything.
Oh.
You know,
who's making your ear for you?
Well, I've gone through surgeries ever since I was about 6 years old.
Wow.
And
what was school like not having an ear? Because, you know, kids can be very understanding.
Well, that's when I had long hair. I cover it.
Nobody knew you didn't have an ear?
Not for years.
What happened when you went out on a date and a girl's messing around? Did you tell her ahead of time you didn't have an ear?
Well, I sat there and lost some dates that way.
Well, did you tell them or did you let them find out?
Some I told and some just found out.
What did they say when they found out you didn't have no ear?
Well, let's see. They run to the other side of the car.
What did they say?
And much of nothing. And then you try to call them back and nothing. You know, I mean, much of nothing. They sit there, well, I'm busy. I got this. I got that or whatever.
Mm. So what's there? Is it smooth or is it just a bird?
No, born was smooth. It's just a little thing. They sit there, cut it off, and they split it in half, and then they took skin graft. And part of a rib to build the back half of it.
It's like a bone on the side of your head?
No, rib.
A rib? That's a bone.
Well, yeah. And then they put it on the side of my head to fill it in with skin. And
why don't you just get one of those Mr. Potato Heads and use the parts from that?
Well.
That's plastic.
Thanks, J.D.
Jesus.
Well, it didn't work.
Oh, you can't tell me that's not funny.
It's not.
Even Chris laughed. You got this normal guy, and you got a Mr. Potato Head ear on the side?
No,
I've gone through more hell with this thing all through my life.
But now you're happy about it.
No, I just don't care anymore.
Oh. So you become adjusted to it.
Point.
Yes.
You know, I can't correct it. I can't do anything else.
I understand. Send me a picture of it. I want to see what it looks like.
Hell, I work right by you.
No, I don't want to see him in person.
Oh, freak out, huh?
Well, at least a picture I can turn away.
Oh, damn, it ain't that bad.
Quit it. Send me a picture and put the Mr. Potato Head ear there.
Okay.
All right, thank you.
That's so cold.
That's not cold.
That is totally cold. Obviously, this guy's have a lifetime of trauma.
Did he laugh?
He was laughing.
Did he laugh?
Through his pain.
No, he wasn't.
Yes, he was. He wasn't laughing. He's learned to laugh at himself as opposed to having people laugh at him.
You wouldn't want to see the guy with the potato head ear?
No.
It looked like he was born with a baby ear.
Yes. No, I would not like to see that.
It looked something like this. Look. Hold on.
Don't do this.
Is that close?
Yeah.
We're not laughing at you, Chris.
Yeah, we are. I am. I don't know what you're laughing at.
You're not. It's something you did. That's very traumatic to grow up that way. You know how kids are. Listen, you're doing it. You're not even a kid.
Yeah. He's got a baby ear.
He's got no ear.
Yeah.
And they've built one for him.
Doesn't sound like they're doing a good job.
Well,
why would you stick a rib on the side of your head? Why not just stick a chicken carcass?
I would imagine.
A rib would be, seriously, a dead chicken would look as natural as a rib hanging off the side of your head.
I don't think it's a whole rib. I think it's a part of a rib.
He said a rib. Part so I'm guessing his ear is this big.
No, it's not the size of a real rib. I'm sure it's just a part of a rib to have a skin graft. It'll stay there. I don't know. Quit it. Everybody can't be perfect like you. Little potato here.
Yes, Mark?
Yeah, Russ?
Yes.
Hey. I was calling because I heard you say yesterday that bass players and drummers are useless in bands.
Yes. You hear Great White still going to tour, right?
Oh, they are?
Yeah.
Who's playing guitar?
They're going to find somebody else.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, you know, most of these bands are kind of formed around the rhythm sections before they add the secondary instruments like guitars and vocals.
All right, what do you play, drums or bass?
Drums.
Nice. Anybody can play drums. And you certainly, you know what, I don't even know why bands have bass players. You can't hear them.
Well, they balance out the sound of the band.
No, they don't. You can't hear them.
Sure they can.
You could take a bass player completely out of the mix, and nobody would ever know.
You think?
Yes, absolutely.
Led Zeppelin would have sounded like the Chieftains without a bass and drums.
You'd never heard bass.
AC/DC would sound like Gypsy Kings.
Hey, hand me my rock CD out of my bag. It'll just say rock and stuff on it. No, you don't need a bass player. Anybody can play drums. You can play any. You could interchange drummers from one band to the next, and they would compensate really well.
You think?
Bass player, totally out of the mix. Who's going to notice?
Everyone would notice.
No, they wouldn't.
Yeah, your stereo in the Batmobile and in the Mach 5 would sound like an AM radio.
Hold on a second.
All right.
Hear a bass player yet?
Nope.
All right. Yeah. You hear the bass?
I'm listening.
You know why you can't hear it?
Because
you don't need it. You talk too much. Do what?
You gotta have it.
You don't have to have it. It does absolutely nothing. Bass players are nothing more than you know why they have drummers and bass players?
Why?
Well, the bass player is to help the drummer carry around the stuff.
Is that what you really think?
Uh-huh.
Yeah?
Listen to this. Do you hear any bass? Do you hear anything?
No.
I hear a drummer.
I
hear guitars. I don't hear no bass. What do you need a bass for?
Bass player's not playing yet.
All right, we'll give it a second. I don't even think AC/DC has a bass player. And if you can go that long without a bass player, you really don't need them because the song's about to kick in.
But the song doesn't kick in until the bass.
So far, I ain't heard a bass player I need. Bass player?
Mm-mm.
Not there.
Lead guitar.
Yeah, there's bass right there.
You can't hear any bass.
I could hear it over here, and I'm listening to the phone line.
I hear drum.
Sorry. No
well, bass. Russ, you play guitar, don't you?
I play that one song. It's not a bass.
Yeah, but...
I mean, if I was going to learn something, I should have picked the bass because it's only got four strings. Not only are you not necessary, you don't even have a full complement of strings.
Well, maybe...
You hear bass?
Uh-huh.
Is that... that's piano.
There it is.
No bass.
Well, maybe you ought to just come out and sit in on bass.
Here comes the bass. In fact, the bass is even less needed than the drummer because you never hear a bass solos in the middle of a concert.
Never.
Never?
A bass solo? Is that bass?
That's bass.
Is that bass?
Right.
That's rock bass, man.
Well, there you go. Then you go join Ace. go join the Ace tribute band, and you can tour around the country. Thank you. And you can tour around the country playing how long?
And he's playing the same note over and over and over.
You got four strings. How far can you go?
I mean, ever since the beginning of the song, it's the same note.
Go-dum, go-dum, go-dum.
It's still the same note.
Yeah. All right, great. You can travel around the country. You could do this one song. And if you'll notice, Ace only had this one hit.
It's the same note all the way through. I never noticed that.
I can do that. In fact, Everett, when we were, one night we were playing someplace, some station event, and they screwed something up. And they didn't have an amp for me. So I went up there and went, just give me the amp for the bass player. Well, we got to have him. Everett, nobody can hear him. You're not going to be able to tell. With Valerie's moaning and you and me and the drummer, you're not going to need him. Not this one song. One of the CDs I burned over the weekend.
I like it.
That's an MP3.
Really?
Yeah. Sorry, I ain't buying it. Bass players just help carry stuff. They're there to help the drummer. No bass, sorry. I ain't buying your story.
Nice try, though.
Do we have anything to play today, Eddie?
Could the answer be C, the Wizard of Odds?
We haven't played that in a while. Where is it?
It's right here.
True, false stuff?
Yes.
Do we have anything to give away?
Yep.
Yes, Noah?
Yeah, you got to have the bass player, man, in the band.
Why?
Because, I mean, without the bass, the band's not going to be full. You're missing something out of there.
So far, I ain't heard it.
If you play the Stevie Ray Vaughan song again,
mm-hmm.
The House is Rockin',
mm-hmm.
You can hear the bass line in there.
I bet I can't.
Hold on a second.
Let me find it.
You'll hear the walking bass line.
Hold on. Walking bass line. Hold on. Let me listen to this.
Yeah.
I don't hear nothing. I don't hear it.
Don't tell me you don't hear that.
Even if it is, honestly, how much talent does that take?
Yeah.
You could actually do that with your mouth.
Yeah.
I don't hear it.
You gotta hear that.
Shush. Sorry, I still don't hear it.
You don't need
that. A bass player is nothing more than a spleen.
Well, what do you...
spleen?
Yep. It's there. It's there for some reason. You just don't know why. And you can take it out of the equation, and you're not going to miss it.
No, you can't.
Thank you. All right, you just handed it to me. What did I do with them? Does it sit over here?
Yes.
All right. Let's do three for this. Got it? Yes, Bill?
Hey, okay, so if you can do without bass players in the band, how do you explain Flea and the Red Hot Chili Peppers?
You really should pick a better example.
Well, why is that?
What do you mean, how do you explain him? Really, the only reason he's in the band is because he just looks weird and acts like an idiot when he's on stage. It's got nothing to do. If he was just a normal guy, they wouldn't have him. You don't need him.
Well, of course, he's not just a normal guy, though. He's the bass player. Mm-hmm. He's an excellent bass player.
No, he's Flea.
But the band couldn't...
Do you know what he looks like?
Yeah, I know.
There's a reason for that, because he's a freak. He stands out. Otherwise, you don't need him.
But his bass player stands out as well.
Lean. All right. You have all three people? Then here we go. Mm-hmm.
Who's a man with the money, makes a dark day sunny? Who's a fella every day, gives a bundle away? Who's a guy with the prizes that'll light up your eyes? It's never ending, get a friend and get ready to play. Hey, 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 hey. It's the Wizard of Oz.
Wizard of Oz.
The odds are that you'll be a winner today. It's the Wizard of Oz.
Wizard of Oz.
Yeah, the Wizard is here, make you feel okay. Hey, hey, hey.
All right, what are we giving away, John?
All right.
We will be.
Oh, wait a minute. I haven't opened
it. Wizard of Oz, Russ Martin.
All right, what are we giving away?
A 12-month bronze level web hosting service from BurtBiz.com, the official web host of 105.3 FM Talk, and a prize back from Condoms to Go.
All right. We'll make this short because we're running out of time here. All right, let's see here. More bass people. David?
Hey, how's it going, Russ?
Good.
Hey, first time I'm with you. I got one for you. Michael Anthony from Van Halen.
Spleen. Yes, Keith?
Gene Simmons.
Gallstone. Yes, Raymond?
Cliff Burton from Metallica.
Extra kidney. All right, you ready to go?
Yes.
Okay. Let's get our contestants on the phone. Sean, welcome to the show.
What's up?
What do you do for a living?
Survey.
Survey?
Yeah.
You like at the mall?
No, land survey.
Oh, okay, cool. What about you, Ryan? What do you do?
Porn star.
Okay, and Chris?
What's happening? Electrician.
Electrician. All right. Here we go. We're going to ask you guys true false stuff. You'll have to decide if it's true or false, and whoever has the most at the end of the game wins a fabulous prize. Everybody got it?
Yep.
All right.
Got it.
Here we go. Andy Garcia was born with a conjoined twin the size of a tennis ball attached to his shoulder.
Ryan.
Everybody gets to answer. Everybody hold on. Odd fact, true or false? Sean?
All right. Ryan interrupted. Repeat the question.
Andy Garcia was born with a conjoined twin the size of a tennis ball attached to his shoulder. True or false?
Oh, false.
False. Ryan?
True.
True. And Chris?
True.
True. Actual answer? True.
So Ryan and Chris get one.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Of course, the guy called earlier, he didn't have no ear. Marilyn Manson had two ribs removed so he could perform oral sex on himself. Odd fact, true or false? Sean?
True.
Ryan?
True.
And Chris?
True.
Odd fact? Is false. Billy Bob Thornton believes that he is the reincarnation of Benjamin Franklin. Sean?
Oh, this guy's a weirdo. That's true.
Ryan?
Gotta be true.
true.
And Chris.
Gotta be true.
In fact, it was true. William Shatner tries to maintain a youthful look by coating himself in Chunky-style peanut butter. Odd fact, true or false? Sean?
False.
Ryan?
Yeah, true.
True. And Chris?
True.
Odd fact, is false. What's the score so far, John?
All tied up now, two each.
Okay. Mark Wahlberg was born with three nipples, one of which he covers up with makeup while filming. True or false? Sean?
True.
Ryan?
You gotta be false.
And Chris?
True.
True. Odd fact? Is true. Who's got the kid?
Yeah.
Chris.
Is that yours, Chris?
Yeah, it would be mine.
Eat him. What is he saying? What's he want? What's he need?
He wants to come out in the garage to play.
Ain't you got no matches?
Hey.
Damn.
Hold on. Here's the matches. Okay.
All right.
Don't
next one. Warren Beatty's job before he became famous was to chase rats out of a hotel. Odd fact, true or false? Sean?
True.
Brian?
True.
And Chris?
False.
Odd fact? It's true. Daryl Hannah wears a prosthetic finger to cover up the one she cut off as a child. Sean, true or false?
False.
Ryan?
False.
And Chris?
True.
Odd fact? It's true. Samuel L. Jackson was once arrested for exposing himself in a McDonald's by sticking his penis in a Happy Meal. Odd fact? True or false?
False.
Sean is false?
Yes.
Ryan?
False.
And Chris?
False.
Odd fact? It's false.
Oh, yeah.
Do-do-do-do-do-do. Let's see. What else? What's the score? Oh, the kid's done with the matches. Hurry up.
Ryan's got four. Sean and Chris are tied at five.
Okay. Let me know when we break the tie.
So all right.
La-da-da-da-dance. Lou Costello's last words were that that's the best ice cream I've ever tasted. Odd fact, true or false? Sean?
True.
True. Ryan?
True.
True. And Chris?
True.
Odd fact? Is true. We ain't broken the tie, have we?
Nope.
All right. Oh, we have another page. Good. Chris?
Yes.
Did you decide to have the whole effing family on the garage while you're doing this?
I'm trying to get my wife to get in. You know, she's trying to take the matches away from me.
Are they back in the house now?
Yeah, they're back in the house.
I still hear it.
I just want to shut the door.
Don Hemig was arrested after a 16-year-old hooker overdosed in his hotel. True or false, Sean? Ryan?
True.
And Chris?
True.
Did you say true?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Odd fact? Is true. Anybody winning yet?
No, Sean and Chris are still tied.
Angie Bowie said she once caught David Bowie in bed with Mick Jagger. True or false, Sean?
True.
Ryan?
True.
Chris?
True.
Odd fact? True. Still tied?
Yep.
David Lee Roth made his road manager wash his feet with Perrier water after concerts. Odd fact, true or false? Sean?
True.
Brian?
True. False.
False. And Chris?
True.
Odd fact? Is true. Still tied?
Yep.
Joey Ramone, in a drug-induced trance, stapled his scrotum to a wooden chair so he wouldn't fall out of it. Odd fact, true or false? Sean?
False.
Ryan?
True.
And Chris?
True.
Odd fact? False.
Here you go. We have a winner.
Who is it?
It is Sean.
The only one he's got.
All right. Sean will get a Condoms to Go prize pack packed with all kinds of cool lifestyle stuff from Condoms to Go and 12-month bronze level web hosting service from BurtBiz.com, the official web host of 105.3 FM Talk.
What is it, Ronnie?
Geddy Lee from Rush.
Appendix.
Appendix. With three people in a band, you got to hear the bass.
No. Or tonsils. Take your pick.
More of the Russ Martin Show coming right up.
I don't remember what you're talking about.
Just
and no, I did not trash the car up.
Yes, you did.
In fact, that wasn't even the word that you used.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is. Yeah, neon on the pedals.
So what?
Neon gas pedal, neon brake pedal on a Batmobile. It looks retarded.
That's not what you called it either.
It is.
No, I didn't. You said I messed it up.
I did not.
Yes, you did.
Messed it up.
That's not what you said.
Yeah, you're making things up.
Mm-mm. And why is that? And why is that? And up.
Red neon on the pedals is not, that's got nothing to do with the original car.
I can see the pedals now. That car is so dark down there on the floorboard, you can't see squat.
You don't know where the pedals are?
I know where they are.
My pedals aren't lit up either.
But I can see them now.
I can't, I don't need my pedals lit up. I don't look down there to see where my pedals are. I just know where they are.
All I know is I was offended when you said what you said.
I didn't say that. But you did. Mess it up.
That is not messing it up.
It's red neon at a Batmobile. It doesn't need any more anything. It's gaudy enough as it is. It's got red bats. It's got rocket launchers. It's got radar. It's got television cameras. It's already messed up enough. You don't need red neon pedals. Don't you think you've gone overboard?
Nope.
Where are you going to stop?
I'm done.
You ain't done. He'll do something else to it. You got neon back behind the seats.
That's so you can see the amp when you pull the seats forward.
Why do you need to see the amp?
In case I need to do something.
What?
Plus, it's got the cutout 3D bat logo and the neon backlights it.
Very nice. It's enough. The pedals are too much.
The pedals aren't too much. And I didn't end it up.
I never said that.
That is exactly what you said.
No.
Yes, you did.
No.
You said I ended up.
You Pleasant Groved it up.
Mm-mm.
Yes, you did. You've taken it too far. It's enough. Will you stop now, at least?
What do you care what I do to it?
I just say it ceases to be an original when you add
You can't even
it.
See that in the pictures. I had to show you that. You can't see almost anything that Tyson added. You can't see the speakers. You can't see the stereo. You can't see the amp. You can't see anything. I had to show you all of it.
That's true. You can see the neon pedals.
You're supposed to. It's neon. I didn't end it up. And I'm offended. I am offended that you even brought that up.
I didn't.
A, it ain't your car, and B, that's racist.
I didn't say that.
Somebody did.
Possibly you.
Mm-mm. All right, what was the thing you were talking about?
I was just saying
before you said I end up the car?
Dr. Phil's show, and I said that last night. His show, Fighting Fair, was on today. Fighting Fair.
That was yesterday.
I thought this was today.
You're the one that brought it up. I don't know.
Anyway, we just talked about Dr. Phil sends cameras into people's homes. And
oh, yeah, this was yesterday because I was going to address this and we forgot about it.
How to fight fair and stop with all the name-calling, temper tantrums, and hitting below the belt. Also, the number one predictor of divorce and what you can do to prevent it.
See, just another reason that he's screwed up.
What?
And all therapists do this. They make both people in the argument think that they both have a valid point. And what that does is it drags it out. I have been to counseling with a chick before.
What?
Two or three times.
Twice?
Three times, yeah. And what's the first thing the therapist does? Well, you know, you have to understand that she has a point. No, she doesn't. And just by the fact that you said that, you have a degree, now she thinks she has a point, and she's going to bring this up every effing time we have an argument.
It's like the doctor told you.
The doctor said I had a point. No, he was just trying to keep you from feeling like an idiot. Because their philosophy is nobody should walk away from an argument feeling like they lost. Yes, you do. You don't want to make arguments inviting. Because if you think you're going to win regardless, you'll have arguments all the time. There's got to be a penalty.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Quite aware. But, yeah, that was his show. How to fight fair and make it fun.
I remember we went to see Dr. Thornton one time.
Mm-hmm.
This was the tall blonde that I was dating that was on coke. Of course, I didn't know she was on coke at the time. And I saw him one time without her. Then she gets in there, and he goes, well, she's got a point. I looked over him, and I went, I didn't say anything. You just give him the eyeball like, we're going to get her in here. And then I'll be damned. Every time after that, she brings up, well, Dr. Thornton said I was right. No, he said you had a point. Totally different. The point you had was wrong. And you have to, you just can't let this continue.
But Dr. Phil would be off TV if he didn't make women feel like they had a point. That's his whole thing.
They don't have points.
Mm-hmm. He wants them to feel...
Anytime you validate something stupid, they keep doing the same crap.
That is true.
But if you were a therapist and they came into your office and you go, okay, I see your point. I see your point. Let's see if we can both have each other, see each other's point of view.
Right.
What does that do? That stretches it out into weeks and weeks and months of therapy. Mm-hmm. That way they can make $145 for 45 minutes for years.
Unfortunately, you're correct.
If the chick comes in and you look at her and go, all right, you're wrong. You need to shut up. Here's why. He's right. And if the guy happens to be wrong on occasion, you tell him and you get that over with. But every time you validate somebody's stupid point of thinking.
Drag it out. Well, if they solved you in one session, they wouldn't make any money.
And then you start having a real fight in front of the doctor, and you start telling her how stupid she is. Well, you don't need to be name-calling. Yes, you do. Like I said before, don't be one. Don't get called one. Those are really good rules. And right now, she's being a C. Of course, they'll never side with you there, even though I'm paying for it.
Name-calling never works.
Work for me.
You're not with that girl anymore, so...
I'm making you... Ask her, she was a nut. She was a doper. She was on coke.
It's true.
I didn't know any of that. And when she was on coke... when she wasn't on coke, from what I could tell... Because she would tell me different instances where we had really big fights. She didn't have access to her nose candy. There was no toot. She was tootless.
And so she would argue then?
Yeah.
She would get aggravated?
She would go back and go, you remember this particular instance? Because we were going to go someplace, and I forgot. We got into an argument about something, and we had the entire weekend... We're going to go look at antiques and everything planned out. We got into an argument. She goes, take me home. But no, why don't we just see if we can work our way through this? Just be cool. We've had an argument. We came to a meeting of the minds. We're going to go have a good weekend. No, take me home. So you're going to ruin the whole weekend. Even though I'm willing to concede, I'll say I was wrong. Will that make you feel better? Take me home. Took her home. She called me an hour back. Come get me. She went home, did coke.
Oh, okay.
I didn't know it at the time. Afterwards is when she finally fessed up. Remember the day we were going to go blah, blah, blah? Yeah. I had you take me back home so I could do a couple of lines of toot.
Mm.
Don't be it. Don't get called one.
Good philosophy there. That one I believe in.
If you're a chick and you're listening, learn this. This will save you a lot of grief, a lot of time and trouble over the future. Don't be it. Don't get called it. It's a simple philosophy. It's really easy. Say it to yourself quietly in the car. See? Possibly one more time for affirmation. Don't get called it. See? See how easy that was? Don't we all feel better?
Yes. You didn't charge them $150.
No. You're better. You're going to go home. You're not going to have an argument. If you're wrong, just... Take your medicine. The stairs aren't that high.
Quit it.
Are you waving the log again? Huh. Well, they're not.
No.
Free advice. And damn good advice, I might add.
It certainly is.
Look at the ratings. We wouldn't be number one if I didn't know what the F I was talking about. We'll be back.
More of the Russ Martin Show coming right up.
All right, we only got a couple of minutes. Run down the rest of them.
All righty. Dr. Phil. Take it private, keep it private. Fighting in front of your kids or your neighbors is not good.
Now, once again, you got to have a penalty. Got to embarrass her in front of the neighbors. The kids isn't good. My parents would fight in front of me. That would scare me.
Yeah.
So he's half right on that one.
Okay.
But in front of other people, absolutely. There has to be some type of penalty.
Okay.
If she thinks that you're going to prove that she's wrong in front of other people, she'll keep her yap shut.
Keep it relevant. Don't bring up old grudges or, women do this so much. Don't bring up old grudges or sore points when they don't belong in a particular argument. Keep it relevant. Focus.
Hang on, I'm going to tell you why that's wrong.
Okay.
Sometimes you have to bring other things into the argument.
Like if she's repeating the behavior that she did a couple of years ago at a party.
Right, same thing. Or, absolutely. Or other things that she screwed up.
Right.
You have to show her that she's got a pattern.
Right.
Whether it's got anything to do with that argument or not, you have to bring the whole thing in. You have to look at it comprehensively.
You've done this before. You're doing it again.
I'm not you're actually talking about something relevant. I'm talking about something that's irrelevant.
Oh.
Other things that she screwed up has nothing to do with this argument. Right. You just have to show her that she's got a pattern.
Oh.
You screwed this up, you screwed this up. There's a really good chance you left this up, too.
I see. Keep it real. Deal with what really is at issue, not with a symptom of the problem. I don't get that one.
Oh, I know what he's talking about. It's just still rhetoric. We'll skip that one.
All right. Avoid character assassinations.
Nope, you have to do that as well.
Stay focused on the issue rather than deteriorating to the point of attacking your partner's personality. Mm-hmm.
Because if they start thinking they actually have a point or their self-esteem rises to a certain level,
right.
They think they have a point, you have to take that away from them.
Don't let the fight degenerate into a name-calling.
Name-calling is the best. I absolutely enjoy that. And I've even given you a rule on how not to be called names. Don't be it. Don't be it. Don't get called it.
There you are.
That's as simple as I can make it.
Okay. Remain task-oriented.
I'm going to have to stick out a book on how chicks just to deal with guys and to make it through a relationship without having any problems. That would be on the first page. You know how I told you I was going to write a book?
Right.
And each one page would have one thing to do. Right. It's a crapper reader.
Sure.
You sit on it, you read, it's like a thought for the day. Mm-hmm. That would be the first page. Don't be it. Don't get called one.
I like that one. I like
the only thing is, that really takes care of the rest of the pages. After that, what else do you really need?
Well, that's just about name calling, pretty much. There's other ways to fight.
All right.
Remain task oriented. We already do that one?
I don't know
what you want going into the disagreement. If you don't
just tell them they're wrong.
Okay. Allow for your partner to retreat with dignity.
No.
How an argument ends is crucial.
Mm-mm.
No.
Mm-mm.
Well, isn't that a win-win? Then you both win.
Exactly.
You get your point, but she can save face.
Mm-hmm. She has to know that she was wrong. She has to know that she peed the carpet. You have to let them know that they did wrong. In a war, can you have two winners?
No.
Okay.
All right. Be proportional.
Do you think President Bush is sitting in the White House thinking, okay, how can I help Saddam Hussein save face without wiping his ass off the planet? I can't. Oh, well.
Be proportional in your intensity. Every single thing you disagree about is not an earth-shattering event or issue.
It is if she's wrong.
You don't have to get mad every time you have a right to be.
He just contradicted himself. You have a right to be mad. Why not take advantage of it? If you don't take advantage of your rights to be mad,
right.
You're short-sheeting yourself. I hate to quote Paul Lynn from the Hollywood Squares,
okay.
But to thine own self be true.
I see.
I heard him say that one time.
I got you. And finally, there is a time limit. Arguments should be temporary.
No time limit. There's no time limit.
So don't let him get out.
You need to take as long as you need to take to show her how wrong she is. Never, ever let them leave thinking they're right.
I see.
But still my favorite.
Yes.
Don't be one. Don't get called one.
That's beautiful. Dr. Russ's tips for fighting.
I'm writing a book.
That's it. That's all.
All right, it's after 7. You ready to go?
Yep.
All right, you got your plugs?
I got them.
Okay. George drove me to work yesterday, so I'll throw his plugs in there.
Okay.
All right, go ahead.
All right, for more information on the Russ Martin Show, to email us or for details on the Listener's Foundation, police or firefighter poster, you can catch it all at RussMartin.com. To instant email us during the show, send it to studio@RussMartin.com. To see Trey and visit his website, go to TreyTrenholm.com. To find Eddie on the World Wide Web, EddieBoyd.com. To visit me and my picture gallery, go to JohnDavidRyan.com. Limousine service provided by Ultimate Limousines. Call George at 214-668-5363. Also, food provided, we forgot to do this last week, by 36 Degrees at 4140 Lemon Avenue in Dallas. Very good seafood. And the official site for the Talk That Rocks is 105.3 FMTalk.com.
All right, see you guys tomorrow.
See ya.